We're good to go. Metal Gear Rising is on. Saba already messaged me saying that she was gonna be a little late today. She's on a hike.
Oh.
He took a hike.
Just like I told her to.
Yeah, I was gonna say, you told her to take a hike. And so she did. She's, you know, going in the outdoors.
All right. So, Grant, you may or may not recall better than me, but aren't we, like, pretty close to the end? We just did the, Sundowner boss fight.
I said it, I think, earlier, but I've never played this game.
Yeah, but
I believe
you seem
Sundowner
familiar
is,
with it.
Yeah, I believe Sundowner is, like, either the, second or third to last boss.
Because obviously we have the senator. Oh my god, what
yes,
happened? There you go.
What is happening?
F. I don't know what that was, but that was weird.
Obviously we have the college ball star, you know.
X. Oh no. Shit, sorry, that was my bad.
He played college ball, you know.
He played football, you know.
He's covered wars, you know.
He's covered wars, you know.
Yeah. He's played with balls in college, you know.
Ooh.
Who hasn't?
Good for him.
There should
Collegiate
be another F.
Balls.
There you go. Can I not parry that one when it's a stab?
Ooh.
Oh, okay. All
no
right, sir. Come on.
Three hit combo.
There you go.
There you go.
I want to get his arm. No, I wanted to get his arm.
Oh,
I'm gonna chop him through the chest and then try to cut off his arm. All right.
I wish we could rewatch that previous cutscene because that was
all
dope
the
as
fucking
gold.
With the drones and shit. It was hype as hell.
Brains out of here. And what will you do?
Get out.
Hi, doctor. You left our ass.
Yeah, you left our ass, dude. Like, what the fuck?
You even saluted like one by
us. Like we were gonna die, and it's like, what are you talking? We're fine. We're raiding, dude. Just like wait a second, and we'll run up a building to come get you.
If you are struck by one of those, your sacrifice shall not be in vain.
Let me just some distance between. All right. So now our current objective appears to be what the fuck? Who's from Texas that keeps calling me?
It's me. Hey, Zach. It's your old cousin, Dan.
I'm not using the mouse right now.
It's Texas Dan.
It's Texas Dan. I'll fight with my feet.
Have I got an oil rig to sell you?
Oh, Texas Dan and his get-rich-quick schemes.
Yeah.
Oh! I forgot
that's
about that.
Expected.
Well, that's effective. God. Don't forget, you have a target lock on if you want it, Lawrence. Yeah, like that. Lawrence learned how to steppy in the last episode.
Steppied.
Yeah, Lawrence steppy. Can steppy now by hitting the Z key. He has the ability
like
to do a dash step while flashing.
Congratulations.
Yeah, I upgraded.
The weapon to surpass Metal Gear.
Steppy.
I don't even know how we did this.
I don't know. Parried his charge, maybe?
Oh.
What just happened?
Oh.
Well,
I wasn't expecting an execution there. Oh, okay. Let's do it
coming
again.
Coming in. Doing it again.
Slam that right key. And then we can execute. No?
Now we can. Okay, sure. Fine. Good enough. Get him. Get his ass.
Get his ass.
Get the ass.
You tryna get the ass.
Oh, I saw that. Parried without even seeing him.
We're true ninjas.
Yes! So it is parrying the charge.
So
that's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Okay, so we can execute directly after that. Bullseye! Oh yeah, Lawrence was laughing hysterically in the last episode because Raiden's voice acting gets really poor. depending, like,
or
like not poor.
Definitely not my description.
No. But I mean, like, it gets like more ridiculous the more bloodthirsty he is.
Oh, yeah.
So right after we defeated Sundowner and we like chopped him to a million pieces, Raiden does like a line with like, "What happened in 3 hours?"
Yeah, it was like super. It was like more extra than he usually does.
Foaming at the mouth.
Yeah,
foaming at the mouth. But like the best part is like after he's done talking to Sundowner's body. He's like, "Alright, Sundowner, I'm gonna hang out, we're gonna talk to my other friends." Picks up his other friends. "Oh hey guys, so we have another problem."
Oh, we have to save them. Oh, hello, fellows.
Hello, fellows.
Oh, this is kinda clever. It's the same level but backwards,
oh, yeah.
So they don't have to make any new assets. Oh, I guess I had to deflect that twice.
So speaking of Metal Gear games, I was watching a bunch of stuff from the Phantom Pain yesterday, just rewatching like cutscenes and stuff, and that game's really fucking good, but also really ridiculous.
It's really funny seeing like postmortems on Phantom Pain, because you can clearly tell whether or not somebody whether or not their priorities were fan of video game or fan of Metal Gear as like a franchise. Because people who are fans of like the Metal Gear story and lore or whatever think that Phantom Pain sucks, because apparently it has a lot of issues when it comes to like continuity and explaining stuff. But on the other hand, man, that game's awesome.
That game fucking rules.
Lingua Franca. She breathes through her skin, obviously.
Yeah, okay, Kojima.
She breathes through her skin, that's why her tits need to be out. Duh.
Yes,
all right, Revolver Ocelot.
Yeah. Anyway, here's a fucking robot that you can drive and drift with. Did you ever use D-Walker? I always use like Quiet or D-Dog.
I never used Quiet D-Walker. Almost all the time, because you could instruct her to snipe a target from like far away. And
exactly, Quiet was fucking broken.
And like she would be so far away that like you didn't even need to give her a silencer, because that's how like the gunshot couldn't be
heard.
It didn't
matter.
Like, yeah. It was so ridiculous, and I was like, yeah, if I'm gonna do like stealth shit, I obviously want Quiet. Like, D-Dog's pretty good, obviously, but I will admit, I didn't
read.
Look at this, Grant. They just put, like, Japanese porn actresses in the game.
What is this? Yakuza?
The devs got bored while they were building the scenery, so they had to put in something for their entertainment.
I wish we had like, an aerial stinger. You know what I mean?
They have another monitor, so I have to put on their support monitor to work.
I like the idea of the platinum dev team only having one monitor each. One to share among all of them.
Yeah.
Everyone shares
a 16-inch monitor.
You know how if you hold the Windows key and then hit a direction, it'll like automatically snap the window to like a different position.
Yeah, they have like 50 billion windows.
Yeah, they have a unique configuration where they can keep tapping the button over and over in order to make it like smaller and smaller.
They'll just make a checkerboard pattern of windows.
Right, you're Ripper Mode. This may not have been the best time for Ripper Mode, but I will do my best.
Oh.
That was excellent. Holy shit. What the fuck? Dude, Ripper Mode's ridiculous.
Hell yeah, dude.
Like, I know it's literally just like, oh, double your attack and now you're constantly in blade mode or whatever, but like, Jesus.
You see, this is what happens when I get angry.
When I get angry, my voice becomes more raspy.
Why are you Krusty the Clown?
Hey.
I like the tripods just hanging out.
And they're like, oh, and they jump on you.
Yeah.
Like they explode like party poppers. Like, it doesn't seem that hard to get rid of them. I wonder if civilians would be able to handle the tripods.
This is your problem now. Raiden's got more important stuff.
I will mark the heading on your Soliton radar.
Hi, bud.
Oh, it's a tomboy or whatever it's called.
What?
whatever this thing, the slidey guy.
I dream of a world where everyone can have a thick tomboy GM. Yeah.
I feel the same.
Both together we'll rid the world of shit taste.
Oh, come on, squeeze it there.
Oh, shit. Oh no. First time chatter is in chat and immediately was like, you mean the grad? Which is apparently the name of this enemy type. Blatant insect. I'll have you know it's called a tomboy.
Why do you call it a tomboy?
I thought they called it a tomboy at some point. I thought they did. I guess I'm like super wrong.
Just a bit of a Freudian slip there, Zach.
I'm just messing. What? Wait, do tomboys usually slide around like that?
We missed that shit so hard.
You know what it is? It's the Heelys.
Tomboys are known for their Heelys.
Yeah. You can't be a tomboy.
It's quintessential to the tomboy aesthetic is to have Heelys. Yeah. You know? Where are we going? Oh, we got a slice.
Right here.
Right. Makes sense.
Right through.
He was tomboy, also skater girl.
Hello, Sama. Welcome to chat.
Obvious.
I will contact you when I am on the ground.
Oh, it's a gorilla.
Bitch. Hit that bitch.
That did next to nothing. We should get out of this. You got a steppy. You're going to have to steppy. You're going to have to steppy. Yeah, good steppy.
I was like, can't do it early.
There's a lot of stuff behind us.
Second gorilla.
That would surely ruin my day.
Indeed. Oh, shit.
We're going to want a blade storm, I think. Never
mind. I think
you
want to heal.
All right, let's do
what
this.
What? That's a triple.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we don't get any bonuses for that? Come on, now. That's not fair. That's cool as shit. Also, this guy has no legs, and he's still coming at us. Oh, never mind. He exploded.
Oh,
man. That's so cool. I'm so embarrassed that as soon as I made the tomboy mistake, a random person in chat, never ever been to the stream before, is like, you grad? I'm so embarrassed. Treasure chest.
Who the fuck is this guy?
Who's calling it a tomboy?
So who's this red? Why is there red here?
What are you talking about?
Is there not a red dot?
Oh, wait, slash his door.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
What the fuck?
That dude just came back from the bathroom.
I think he actually did.
That Metal Gear has done it many a time.
Many a time.
Oh, that's awesome.
Oh my god.
Yeah, he just had some. He had some VP on him.
Yeah.
Some bitch points.
Bitch points.
He was here just playing Minecraft on the computer.
They have a server going.
Oh my god!
Dude,
wait,
those are the mods.
Why is there just a bunch of watermelons in here? There's three gorillas. Yeah. Steppy.
They're the mods on
You're gonna want to ravage, or whatever. What's it called?
Oh, okay.
Mode.
Ravage them.
You're gonna want to.
Oh, I was trying to steppy that.
Holy shit!
Right? Eat this.
There you go. What?
There
He's just
go.
Floating.
That's all we need. What is happening?
I don't know, but we did it. Oh,
congrats.
Fuck you and your seat.
Fuck you.
Blade mode. Blade mode. This. Oh, we can't.
Blade mode. This
no.
Shit. I can do that.
Chop into watermelons.
Delicious.
Delicious.
What are you guys' opinions on watermelons?
Awesome.
I don't like them.
Especially during the summer.
It's very inconsistent. Sometimes they give me swollen lips and sometimes they don't.
That sounds like an allergic reaction.
But it's not consistent as a thing. Not all watermelons do it. Not every time I do it. So
are you
I don't
sure
know
you're not sometimes
allergy.
Having aguamelons?
Yes.
Or honeydew.
I'm not multicultural, Zach. I don't speak Spanish.
Aquamelon.
Hello? Who's this?
That should do nicely.
Oh, is he just stealing a civilian's motorcycle?
Oh, you know.
Hot damn, dude. Shit. Why did they have to make the cyborg body have all the muscle parts?
Because he's hot.
I need
as
your
hell.
Bike, thank you for your cooperation. And then a phone number.
King shit.
That's awesome. That's so good.
That was a short level.
It was. They needed to make, I don't know why we did that.
As we were dropped from the sky, and we were just here all willy-nilly.
Yeah, so it was just such a weird filler level.
Yeah.
All right, I don't know if we can afford anything else.
Not even a boss fight. Yeah, we can.
No.
Yeah, we can.
No.
Yeah, we can.
Yes.
No.
Yeah. Oh,
fine.
Yeah.
Do it.
Yes.
Okay, we're mariachi now.
What we are the greatest.
Whoa, wait, go to the main. Go to main weapon. Can we afford the? No. The fox blade is fox how much? Blade. 200.
Too rich.
Oh.
200.
Too rich for my blood.
We were four tenths of the way there in a minute ago, man.
Yeah, but now we got drip.
That's true. Saba agrees with this outcome.
Yes.
Exactly.
For cultural appropriation, Raiden.
Did we even unlock any new stuff from that level?
No, I don't think so. I think we only unlock stuff after boss fights.
I'll buy some skills, but
and Lawrence and I were able to confirm that a lot of the abilities that we have been purchasing require coordination between the like directional inputs and the mouse.
So you guys gotta be singular brain.
No, we're just never gonna do it.
You gotta Pacific Rim this shit.
If we do it, it'll be completely accidental.
Can Raiden play guitar? I mean, he's a robot, so he can do anything. I'm pretty sure.
He can download guitar
skills. He can do everything except learn how to play guitar.
That's for humans only.
He's so fucking cool.
He's so fun.
But you would
but
make
can he
cool
play guitar? Checkmate, Raiden.
Maybe with his sombrero and poncho.
Oh, you, maybe.
You know it's going to be ridiculous because a lot of the in-game cutscenes just allow you to keep your suit.
I can't wait.
Hi?
Hello, Blade Wolf.
Oh.
What you doing here, bud?
Are you evil again?
Aw, shucks.
Oh. Jetstream Stam.
Does Jetstream Stam have a larger arm than before, or was it always red?
It was always red like that.
Alright.
He's been doing some serious jacking off.
I have analyzed his words and actions. I am unable to ascertain his motivation.
I don't understand what this fucker's doing.
You here. You knew I'd come. I suppose I should thank you for not killing everyone at the launch site. Well, not if you say it like that. For a hired killer, you're not very good at your job. The war is the big payoff.
What are you talking about?
War is good.
War bad. That's not war bad.
Oh man. I'm not talking about. You see, Raiden, when there's war, I can get a thick body like this.
Yeah, I was just about to say, I think one of the things that I really appreciate about this game is that, obviously, like Mistral aside, I do like that there's a lot of gratuitous ass shots of just dudes.
Oh, look at that.
Look at that.
Yeah.
That's wider than his shoulders, I'm telling you.
They're just keeping with the Metal Gear tradition of the ass shots.
Yeah, there's
oh my god, yes.
We were talking about good and bad cutscenes. I don't know in which category it fell into. Oh, sorry. Sabo says she remembers watching this exact cutscene in class. If you were watching it in class, it was probably in Skolnick's class, and Skolnick hates all Metal Gear writing.
That's true.
So
I like that.
But war bad, Zach.
War bad. Are you telling me he didn't enjoy the Siva Raiders just cutting jets while hacking on another
no,
jet?
No, because that doesn't prove his down. Point, Lawrence. He just wouldn't show that.
This is between us.
What is?
Is it?
It's turned it on his ass!
Yeah!
Maybe that's why the previous level was short, because this is just gonna be a boss fight right here.
This is gonna be rough.
Let's dance.
I love the music that's kicking cool. in, hell yeah.
Oh fuck.
Oh yeah.
Oh shit.
Well, let's go, dude.
Defeat Samuel.
Samuel.
Hello.
And guess what? He has a health bar this time.
Oh, he's
oh my god.
Alright, well he got me immediately.
He's kind of fast.
Use the rocket launcher. Don't ever see it coming.
We will not be using the rocket launcher.
Use it.
Yeah, that's stupid. Launch.
Oh, Lawrence, you can't. This is why I say no rocket launcher.
Use the rocket launcher, Lawrence.
He never expects it.
I can't see shit.
Can't see shit, Captain.
He's in the rock!
I'm gonna...
What are we supposed to do to that? He's too powerful!
He's melded with the rock!
He's melded
with Dwayne Johnson! He's gonna be in every movie ever!
Yeah! And Peacemaker, too.
Dwayne Johnson is Peacemaker, is he?
Is he? No, sorry, that's John Cena, by the way.
John Cena.
That is John Cena, yes.
I get them mixed up. They feel very similar niches to me.
Wrestler.
Yes. Big beefy wrestler.
Dude, this is fucking tough. It's a lot of counter. It's a lot of attack counter. No, it's a bad idea, I think.
This is perfect.
You brought up Peacemaker, Adrian. Have you seen it?
I've seen clips of it. It seems interesting.
Get him.
I think John Cena is a much better actor than Dwayne Johnson.
Very possibly.
Because Dwayne Johnson plays the same role for every movie.
Yeah, but, and John Cena has some comedy chops to him, I would say.
Yeah, that and like, I mean, for a while, John Cena was kind of doing the same thing of just kind of like asshole or big tough man. But in Peacemaker, he actually has a really good range. And it's really interesting because there are moments where he's like very sad and very emotional and vulnerable even.
No, exactly.
But he actually does it very well, and it's like, holy shit.
His acting chops finally.
Yeah, like I don't think they would ever show Dwayne Johnson being like vulnerable.
I don't think Dwayne Johnson would ever allow that.
Has a weakness.
He doesn't. He's like ghost and like dark type or whatever.
Normal ghost.
He's ghost type.
Yeah, he's Spiritomb type. He can't. He has no weaknesses. He's Sableye.
Yeah, yeah. Unlike John Cena, Dwayne the Rock Johnson doesn't have a large glowing red spot on the back of his neck.
Honestly, yeah. He should get that checked out and, you know, probably block
it's
it with
a very... Probably like a metal collar or something.
Unlike Dwayne The Rock Johnson, he doesn't have a suspicious red dot in the middle of his forehead. Bang.
Oh, dang.
He doesn't have a laser sight trained to his forehead.
Oh, he's dead as hell. It's cool.
Chop him. Dude, just chop him.
Oh my god.
You might want a cue. I don't know, maybe.
No.
Oh my god, it doesn't even cover our whole health bar anymore.
Oh.
It only does 100%. Come on, dude. Yeah, like that.
Okay.
He's gonna jump.
Do it again. Do it again.
More like Spamuel, am I right?
Yeah.
I'm retiring.
Come at me.
I peeked.
Nope, I missed that one. Do it again, boyo. Lawrence, stop fucking ninja running at him, please.
Well, he missed.
When you ninja run, I can't parry.
Next time he runs at you, you should surprise him with the rocket launcher.
Yeah. Dodge this, you son of a bitch. Yeah.
Parry this, you fucking casual.
Ooh. God. Okay.
Auto glare from the sun. I can't believe it.
The sun betrayed me once again.
We defeated Sundown and now the sun's after
now
us.
Now the sun is up.
Oh.
Ooh,
oh god. Oh,
that
oh,
was a counter ooh, stance. Oh.
Yeah, it was. I didn't think he would pull that shit.
He's at 14%.
Can you only activate Ripper Mode if we're at 100?
Kick his ass.
Oh,
lock him up.
We're going to have
lock
to cut something. Did you get his hand?
I don't think so.
I think we did.
We are out of the playing area?
I was saying, I think we just accidentally pushed the cutscene out of the play area. And also, blatant insect. Shh, Lawrence doesn't know about that yet.
Blatant
Lawrence
insect?
Lawrence doesn't know about the what you do in the DLCs. Shh, secret.
What are you talking about?
Don't worry about it, Lawrence. All you have to worry about is
me.
Boss fight starts. It's Adrian, but he's just standing there with like a tablet pen.
Yeah. Rules of nature.
There can only be one artist on Oval Stream.
Oh, that's true.
Zach only has enough payroll to fund one of us.
I don't have enough payroll to pay any of you. Why are you
he's hoarding it all for himself, the one percenter.
Lawrence, how about we choose and stab Zach to death?
Excuse you, I'll have you know I'm part of the 0% because I have no money.
I'm part of the 0% that's immune to being stabbed.
Yeah.
0% that's immune to being stabbed.
You are not immune to being stabbed.
No one is. You are not immune to bladed weapons.
We just established that Dwayne Orgas doesn't have any weaknesses. Therefore, he is not vulnerable to being stabbed.
Damn, ID lost on his own.
That would bounce off him harmlessly.
He would flex. He would catch it in between his, you know, biceps.
He would catch it between his eyebrows.
He would, and then he'd turn around.
I was gonna say, and then the Vine Boom sound effect would play.
I would like to do. I don't think there's anything like that in this game, but I know that in God Hand they had a optional enemy type that you could fight that was just like a damage check, where you would start whacking it as hard as you could, and depending on how much time you dealt within a certain lot of time, you would then get like money proportional to how much damage you dealt. I would love that in this, but it just looked like a Wobbuffet. Just like a gooey training dummy sort of thing, where no matter how hard and how fast Raiden fucking cuts it up, it's just immune.
I was gonna say that's where they get the crossover integration. It's this side mini game where they put Wobbuffet in the game.
Yeah, you just beat him.
Yeah, and you just beat him, and then he goes Wobbuffet, and then he cries, and then he pees himself.
Maybe shits.
Yeah, maybe he shits and farts himself.
We don't have any BP. Or okay.
Well, how are you gonna PP yourself?
We need to save money because I want. Wait, what? We need to enhance our damage. Damn
more
it.
More damage.
Yeah.
30,000 out of our 40,000.
Yeah, we're gonna
you
need
can
it.
Do it.
I really wanted to get the actual katana though. A fox blade. You'll sell. Blade. That's gonna be expensive.
Yeah, 30.
60! Holy crap! Oh my god.
Scoob. Any new skills? It would have said new.
It would have said so new, yeah.
All right.
Well, what about
let's get out of here.
Wait, I want to see if we got.
We don't get his weapon.
Because they were talking about like an ID
locked. His DNA signature.
I gotta say that we were pretty respectful with Sam. It's like flashback to the other three boss fights we had. We cut them down into millions of pieces.
Because my understanding is that Sam is supposed to be like the honorable samurai sort of thing, in the sense that he only does what he does because he likes to fight. This guy's mouth is fucking weird. Oh, what the fuck are you reading? So kawaii.
What? No. They're gonna find out about my anime love.
Wait, isn't this in Texas?
Yeah. He's a fucking weeb.
Mr. Raiden, sir?
I was playing Project Zomba one time and went out to a farmhouse in the middle of nowhere. And it was boarded up and we went inside and we found three ninja swords in this one teenager's bedroom.
Where is she?
They're just thinking like, what kind of fucking Kentuckian weeb got these?
Was it Saba's room?
Kentucky?
Yeah. Saba moved to Kentucky and back. Hey, stranger. Just for the apocalypse.
Wait, is this, is this Paz?
No, Paz is dead as shit. Yeah, this is,
at this point in the story?
Yeah. This isn't. This. Snake is dead as shit right now.
Nah, I don't believe you.
Yes, that's what happens in the fourth one. Is like,
what about Gaseous Snake? Oh, he got mad!
What? Gaseous Snake. Not really. This is, follow me. What's his face's daughter? This is Huey's daughter.
Not Huey. Huey. Lewis?
It's Huey Lewis in the news.
Huey!
No, Owl's daughter, I think. Otacon.
Wait, that doesn't make any sense. If Paz is already dead at this point, how does she show up in MGS5?
Yes, Zach. It's almost like it was like a PTSD hallucination.
That's stupid.
You know what else is stupid? The lingua franca.
Wait, what the fuck is happening? Are we going in space?
It uses a hybrid lace ramjet engine I designed.
When? Did I miss that?
I don't know.
I thought we were going after the senator. Is the senator in space?
He could be.
I guess
he's playing
so.
Ball in space.
Yeah. No, he's playing space ball.
He's playing space ball.
Depending on how this looks, like if we have an actual level in space, this might be exactly like that one level from Metal Wolf Chaos. No-smoking flight.
Roger.
Also, hates child.
Ignition! Your like, hatred for smart children.
You're like 6 years old. You do not know what you're doing. Get out.
Your hatred for smart children will never make me laugh. Never not make me laugh. Double negative.
Hate it.
It's just the hyper prodigy archetype that I hate so much. You could have like, I don't know, I like what was her name? Pearly. I like Pearly, she's great.
The only savant thing Pearly has going is that she's amazing at kicking your ass.
That's true.
That's kinda true. Well no, she was also a really good medium, right? Yeah. Well, she was a small one.
Well,
but
she was tiny, yeah. I don't know about medium.
Well, I mean, when she did that crime, she was at large. She was a small, medium, and large.
Wait, what the fuck? Yeah.
So, are we Mars? It was just a really fast jet?
Sick.
Hell yeah, dude.
Raiden is like 98% metal at this point. Just fucking load him into a gun and shoot him, for Christ's sake. We don't need the
just
rest
put
of
him...
this.
Big magnet wherever you need him to go. As he just flies by.
Oh, I know we already fought Monsoon, but that'd be a great boss fight, dude, where it's just like a guy with a tablet where he's just like boop boop boop. It's just like a big magnet starts sucking you towards the wall.
No.
Like, excuse me, Raiden. How do I not just defeat you with an EMP? Oh my god. I forgot.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot.
I think we're gonna finish game this stream.
Well, we're gonna finish the main campaign.
Yes.
Because we will be doing both DLCs.
Okay, cool.
Although the first DLC is gonna be kind of rough. Because that character has a much different. Oh, fuck. Well, whatever.
Oh,
just get at him. Get owned!
Come and get them.
Come.
In the wise words of our ancestors, come.
Cool.
Have you guys seen that one post where it's like the streamer and he's like playing Portal and he's like, hey guys, can someone follow real quick? You have to stay. You can unfollow me after. And he's looking at like this giant like tube that's spraying a bunch of white liquid on the floor. And then after a few seconds of delay, it's like, gom. He's like, thanks guys.
Exit codes show up as unaffiliated.
Wait, Marshall has the security contract for this base. Why would they have their cyborg set to the same illegal exit code as Desperado? It's evidence against them.
I forgot about the moon goo from Portal 2.
They're making it look like Desperado hacked their soldiers on site.
Because what they make
that Desperado has a contract with
the Pakistani rebels. If we go public with the Desperado Marshall connection,
won't matter. Not when they've got this nice big foreign threat all cooked up and ready to serve. The media and the public won't be able to resist. Remember WMDs?
Oh, right. They're gonna like kill the president or whatever on his diplomatic trip to Pakistan.
On his birthday? Dead
most likely. On his birthday, yes.
On prom night?
Unbelievable.
Oh.
On his special prom night.
No.
What's that from? Who made the "Who's flying the plane" joke?
I don't know. Like originally?
I'm about to say the original must be lost to time at this point.
Yeah.
I'm wondering if it's just some famous comedian like Abbott Costello, how they did "Who's on First."
If I had to make a wild guess, I'd probably say it would be the airplane movie, like Airplane with an exclamation point.
Oh, that's a good guess.
I love that movie.
I love that movie.
Unfortunately, I don't remember.
I love Who's on First.
Who's
that's
on First?
Who's on First is fantastic.
I think I mentioned this before, but Who's on First is was on that like golden disc that they shot into space.
Yes.
Yeah, to show a lot of people our culture.
Fight them, whatever, man. They're not gorillas. How bad could they be?
Oh, it just slams you into the truck.
It's just like dead.
Yeah.
Fuck! He's shooting their own dudes!
Yeah, I'll just stand right
so
here,
now
right in between them.
The power of the rocket launcher.
Yeah, yes. But the problem is that after the rocket launcher, we don't really have any chance to recover. Alright, slash him. X.
Nah, there was no X.
There was nothing? That's weird.
Nope.
Oh my god. Dude, you lost your arm! Just give up! Like, please!
Ooh,
what is White Knight from Monty Python?
He's like, it's but a flesh wound.
Your arm's off!
No, it's not!
No, it's not! There you go.
The original Gaslight Gatekeep Girl Boss.
The Black Knight from Monty Python.
Yeah. He gaslights you this thing, let his arms
not
off.
He was gatekeeping the fridge.
And he's a girl boss because you never see a helmet.
Fuck.
That's true.
I keep chopping them at the elbow. I need to chop them at the bicep. Problem. Now I sound like a doctor.
Really poor doctor who lost their medical license.
I was going to say a Civil War doctor, maybe.
There you go.
Oh, I get it. I have to stop cutting the. I have to go deeper. Yeah.
There was a.
Man, probably could have saved a few people.
There was a reoccurring joke when my sister got her most recent job. Because she works at a
Jesus
clinic.
Christ.
She works at a clinic in the area.
Christ.
Oh, nice. That does prosthetic limbs, right? But
oh,
she
cool.
was. Like, last year around Christmas time, not this year, but like the year before. You don't want to get the camera?
Yeah,
right. Why not? You get some stuff, I think, maybe. Anyway, long story short, during the Christmas season, she was talking about how they wanted to give the employees bonuses, but only if they got enough people to come in to get, like, prosthetics and stuff. And so the joke was that her and her coworkers were laying down landmines in like the local city, so people would lose their legs. God. And it wasn't really that far off, because apparently, like, one of the things that they did was that they would, like, go on social media to find people who were, like, diabetic, because apparently that's, like, the their most that's apparently, like, their most common like, applicant is people who lost their extremities, like their feet and their hands,
to diabetes.
It's like, Jesus Christ, dude. I don't know. I still just think about that. I love the joke of my sister just putting landmines in town to make a quick buck.
This will get it.
This will get him.
Yeah.
You just cut through here?
Sure.
Hey.
That makes sense.
I got him.
Al, what do you mean enemy sighted? You're on the other side of the fucking thing.
He has X-ray vision.
Oh my god, he's swinging fucking so mind? Hard.
Can you just die? The guy got parried like four times. Steppy! No!
Steppy, they're away from the execution. Okay, there
execute.
Execution. Execute spirit evolution.
Okay.
Now quickly jerk him off. Then he won't know what happened when he comes back.
Jerk him off like he's Master Chief.
It was me, Barry.
It was me, Barry.
Give him
that
post-nut clarity.
So I'll have post-nut clarity and not want to fight you anymore. Jerk him off now!
Got it. Perfect. Wait, we're on top of the thing!
Perfect. Oh,
Lauren! Not so perfect. Oh, we almost did the cool thing!
That was the cool thing.
Almost
we already established that.
Blade Wolf!
Oh!
Hey, Grant, are you celebrating Chinese New Year's?
No, I'm Japanese.
Oh.
I'm sorry. You sound so disappointed.
So Sava, Lawrence, and Zach, and one of them said yes. And I wasn't surprised about Zach, but
I was.
Zach's not celebrating Chinese New Year.
No,
surprisingly not. I think Chinese New Year is pretty cool, though. I don't get the whole red envelope with the money thing, though. That just seems like a gift.
I was gonna say, would you not want money from your elders?
I mean, I guess I would, but that's also just not really something that's in our culture. In terms of, like, as white people, you get gifts until you're, like, I don't know, 13, and then that's it forever. And the gifts usually are something along the lines of, like, I don't know, slinky.
Slinky.
I was gonna say,
dude, look at this thing.
I was gonna say, Vietnamese people aren't Chinese, but they still celebrate Chinese New Year's the same, so I don't know.
Oh, are Vietnamese people not Chinese? You should tell that to the Chinese government, then.
Okay,
they're getting a lot of missiles ready.
For what? To nuke Swampland?
Yeah, if you nuke the Swampland, it becomes, like, fine, because it's not wet.
It's literally not worth the ammunition.
Who could it be? Who's the final boss?
Who could it be?
It's so.
I know you. I saw you play
so
ball.
It's so stupid. This is from, like, years and years and years ago. But there was a kid at our school who looked like this, like with the like squarish head, like the square rounded head, giant forehead, like just he looked like this. But obviously we were, you know, not adults, so de-age him a little bit, and people kept making fun of him because it was like I wonder if he's gonna try to take over the United States with nanomachines.
Oh my god.
And then he brought a gun to school so people stopped making fun of him.
Okay,
anyways,
that went from 0 to 100.
That was like years before it became popular to do school shootings.
Popular?
Yeah, it's one of those things where when people who are fucked up in the head see tragedy like on the news, they'll replicate it. So it leads to like a spike in that same tragedy that then dies down. It's the same reason why there was like a spike of serial killers in the 80s and like a spike of school shootings in the mid 2010s, stuff like that. But nothing
to start a major war. Sure, but I don't know. Using the word popularity to describe it is
accurate.
Weird.
Anyways, we're getting Armstrong's speech now. So
about the thick goth GF.
The memes. Nationalism, unilateralism, imperialism.
Welcome maxims for those with no faith, without guiding principles of ismisms.
Their own. Ismisms. Give yourself up to the whole. No need to better yourself. You're American. You're number one. Then the only value left is dollar value. The economy. So we'll do whatever it takes to keep it humming along. Even war. Especially war. Bullshit. The
Patriots. War bad.
War bad.
Kind of right, though.
Yeah, war is
foster
bad.
The memes. You heard it.
The memes. We're all sons of the Patriots now.
We just need something to jumpstart the economy out of this funk. This recession has been stuck in since the fall of SOP. And the military costs? Wasting billions is going to help the economy? DMCs, arms manufacturers.
This would be a much more like emotional debate if one of them wasn't standing on a giant fucking robot and the other wasn't already half robot.
I would love to see this debate like because this feels like a CNN cross like Fox News debate at the moment. I would love to see televised debate like at podiums between Ryden and Senator Armstrong. It's like, and you're gonna waste all this money on the military, really? And he's like, job creators.
I thought you wanted the exact opposite of like it's actual like CNN and Fox
on the presidential debate.
So like they're in this position, one's on a giant robot, the other's on the bottom. They can't hear each other from distance.
Biden standing on a giant Metal Gear, and then the other presidential candidates have to avoid getting stomped on.
Because he's the incumbent president?
Yeah, he's the current president, so they get the Metal Gear.
The current president has to be stronger than the previous president.
Yeah.
This is what Lawrence was talking about, where the Secret Service to train the president.
I lost that bit.
I don't remember how to beat this guy.
Well,
go for his legs. Go for his legs. Oh, we have the steppy. Alright. I thought it said the MS excessive. Go for his
it's
foot.
It's a bit much.
Oh, we can't get his foot.
We cannot. We gotta go for the
hands.
We have
to pay attention to his. We have to pay attention to his big blade.
Can we?
Okay, I thought we could deflect it, but I guess not.
Yeah, you can't melt your
Steppy!
Ray shit.
Come on!
It's hard to know where it is!
On top of
second,
us!
The second you
crushing
look up, it's already falling down.
Wait, where do you think it was gonna go? Like, to our left?
I was waiting for it to drop! I'm telling you, you don't see it drop until it's already too late.
I don't know.
What are you
Lawrence.
Talking about? We're looking at the same screen.
I don't
aren't
know,
we?
Lawrence. I just think that you're not taking this seriously. Oh fuck,
Lawrence, you're freaking out.
You're freaking out. I guess. Wait, did I deflect that or not?
I don't know. I'm kind of dodging.
I can't.
Out of the
our health isn't
that.
Going down.
Yeah, I guess.
What?
You're fine. I guess
we did it. We want to save some of our energy, right? Let's go.
What the fuck? Oh shit! Let's
Ninja
go,
run to that point up there. Where is it? That?
Looks like in Super Mario Galaxy.
Boom! with mega leg.
Yeah.
Those are the same.
This is basically just mega leg.
You remember when Mario
oh, as he falls.
Yeah.
Oh. Shit. You remember when Mario had a samurai sword and was half cyborg and he fought the second?
I thought you said Mario had the gun.
We played that on stream. Gun Mario 64.
Yeah.
Yeah, good times.
I remember when Mario had the samurai sword. That was Paper Mario too.
And half.
That was near door?
On the monkey board.
Yeah.
When did he have a sword? Wait, what?
He had a sword in that game.
Am I thinking of the right one?
No, I mean, he fights samurai in Super Paper Mario, but he never gets a sword. Dang.
Yeah, yeah. He gets a spiritual sword.
He does not.
Yeah, he gets the idea of a sword.
Remember when Mario gets the drill to pierce the heavens and then
the concept of fighting?
Yeah, I remember that.
You remember when Mario invented the concept of murder when he bludgeoned Luigi to death?
With a jawbone or whatever.
With a rock. The jawbone bit, because I had never like really done like Bible study or anything like that. But apparently that was Samson got real mad and murdered an entire city of sinners with a single donkey's jawbone.
That's kind
of
lame.
Like, I'm like, what?
Not very epic.
It's gonna be lasers. Lasers, Lawrence. You're gonna want a steppy. Steppy.
The laser. Oh, into the laser.
I don't know why Lawrence would steppy into the laser, but you know,
it's
trust
hard
him.
To left steppy with
I
a
trust him.
Hand.
I trust Lawrence. He knows what he's doing. Steppy. Steppy.
What the fuck? Get help.
Wait, can we hide behind the geckos?
I don't know.
The hell?
You guys want to know something
Lawrence
funny
continues
I just
to...
saw on Twitter?
What did
you see on Twitter?
In every Mario and Sonic the Olympic Games entry, Sonic's the only one who wears a life check in the swimming events.
That's really funny, actually.
You don't like what?
A good detail. And he still competes! You can still choose him! That's fucking insane that you can choose someone who can't swim to compete in the Olympic events for swimming.
Ooh, you like that parry?
The
I don't understand
Olympic
how that parry worked,
guys,
but it was cool.
Hate to do. Like, what would you not want to do the least, and then you are now competing in it?
Oh, that's a good question. I don't know.
Ooh, that was...
Competitive weightlifting?
Competitive weightlifting?
Ah.
Lawrence,
other people. I guess fencing would be because you have like a big suits for those, but boxing or wrestling?
Wrestling.
No thanks. I like my joints how they are.
I think the Olympic event that I would be the least enthused to participate in would be like ping pong or whatever, like table tennis.
Dude,
because...
that'd be sick. What are you talking about?
No. But let me explain. Because table tennis is the one in my mind that is like the most accessible of the sports. Because obviously, like, you still need to be like physically fit in order to do like really well, like Olympically well. But a lot of people would anticipate the idea of just like, oh, he should probably do like okay. It's table tennis. How bad could it possibly be? And then when I get my absolute ass handed to me, and they're like, what's wrong with that guy?
I mean, you think you're gonna perform well in any other event?
No, but what I'm saying is that of the events that are at the Olympics, I think the one that people would assume that Jesus fucking Christ, Raiden. I think it would be the one that people expect. Are we just gonna pick this up and fucking cut him with it? Holy crap, I don't remember this at all. This is awesome.
Going out with a bang.
Am I gonna parry? Oh, I hit the wrong button.
What the
fuck? You fool.
I thought we were gonna parry. So I hit left click, but nah, it was right click.
You absolute fool.
said that I said that I didn't think it needed skill to play. I just said that ping pong, sorry, table tennis is probably the one that most people assume takes the least amount of skill to do, I guess.
You think that other people think it doesn't take skill, but you don't think it doesn't take skill.
Yeah, exactly, right?
Whereas I think it doesn't take skill.
Like, I don't know. I think about, like, curling. I really like how at the Winter Olympics, it's just, like, a bunch of dads. You know what I mean?
He
shouldered
power.
It different. Oh, I hit the. What are you talking about? I thought they would switch. Bam. Why didn't you shift shoulders if you're gonna have the same button? What the fuck?
Foolish. Naive.
So frustrated. And now it's just me. I'm just mashing.
On the other side of the conversation, what do you think you would perform the best at? Or no, Lawrence, you didn't answer actually.
What I would perform the best at?
No, what you would hate to do.
Oh.
Olympic event you would hate to do and would probably do the worst in.
Oh, javelin.
Javelin?
That's specific. I mean, like, because, like, it's that one Olympic sport where I can't. I don't know how they're keeping it straight and accurate.
You think you would spike it into your toe?
Yeah,
just throw it straight down.
Fuck, shit, my foot!
And then they can't get it out, so you just have to stand there.
Well, I mean, as far as your best question, Grant, didn't you say you did archery?
I think I would do the best at archery.
Yeah, probably.
You win!
We're blade sorting with this shit.
I did archery for about 10 years, so.
Let me just stop.
I mean, I'm good at it. Why am I? I didn't stop? I don't know, just didn't have time for it. Went to college.
When you did archery, did you do it with those?
I could have gone pro. I could have gone pro. Played college archery.
Nanomachines.
We haven't done that line yet.
Were you using one of those fancy Daikyu bows?
What'd you just call them?
It's like one of those Japanese bows where you have to like raise it above your head to shoot it.
Just because I'm Japanese? Wow, Adrian. No, I used a compound bow primarily, which is the one with all the fancy gadgets on it.
Oh, you mean the one that's specifically easier to pull?
Oh, sorry. Thank you. You keep right, going. Enough with the
show.
Greg, you're Japanese. Ever use the weeb bow? No, sorry.
The weeb bow. No, I specifically actually learned Western archery, so I don't know how Eastern archery is done. I know it's very different because they do it above their head, and the bows are a lot bigger, and it looks really cool, and I would like to try it. But
I think Eastern archery revolves the other way around the toilet.
Horseback archery.
Yeah,
no, I'd be too afraid that like I'd shoot it in front of the horse and then the horse would lift its head and I'd just kill a horse.
Oh no.
Oh, you're shooting in front of the horse and it's shooting off to the side. Like, that's the point of it.
I think that'd be sick though. I wish I could.
Dude, it's like showing off his thighs.
Oh yeah.
Like ancient step nomads did back in the day.
Yes.
He's absorbing the life stream.
Source.
The Mako reactor. It's in him. Holy
oh,
shit.
What the fuck? He got lied.
I forgot that he just. Yeah, he just gets like twice as much.
Oh, yeah.
Is this what happens when you electrocute yourself?
I'm so wide, Jack.
Oh my
Holy
god.
Holy shit.
Imagine he's just running at you.
Playing college ball, you know.
Some cushy Ivy League school. Oh no, you know what he did, Raiden. You know what he fucking did.
Try University of Texas. Could have gone pro if I hadn't joined the Navy. I'm not one of those.
So Lawrence, what do you think you would do best in an Olympic sport?
Olympic sport.
What about
running?
Holy shit.
Probably something with running. I'm gonna get sprints.
100-meter sprint?
Yeah.
Okay. I think I would do best at power walking.
That's not an own sport.
Yeah, it is.
It is.
No, fast walk,
speed walking. Speed walking's an Olympic sport. It's incredible.
Speed walking is pretty tense on the calves.
I was gonna say, it takes some of this calf muscles.
People are fucking like collapsing by the end because one of the rules is 1 foot has to be on the ground at all times.
Yeah, but can't you watch slowed down footage and see that that's like not true?
That's what they have people there for, to watch.
Say if you watch it and it's not true, then they probably got disqualified.
Yeah.
I'm about to say, I ought to be looking at the same Olympic sport.
Speedwalking's intense.
Lawrence, you got a steppy.
I will say...
No dodging from that.
I will say, my other option is ping pong takes no skill.
No.
Ping pong.
All I'm talking about is you were stuck in a combo.
We would not.
Bro,
you would not.
Absolutely, we are.
Would not.
Nice.
No, my high frequency. Now it's a high frequency Dirk.
I've never successfully skated on ice my entire life.
But what if you were secretly a prodigy and you didn't know?
Then I'd
hate
you.
That's true. There are almost an infinite amount of stills and jobs you could be a prodigy without ever knowing.
Exactly.
You will never know unless you try all of them, even though the likelihood is extremely high you'll be bad at all of them.
What?
At least at the start. But what if I were secretly a prodigy?
What if? And I joined the Olympics. For America.
Jumpstart the economy.
They're having the most fucked up, like, burly fist fight in the world, but yet they're still arguing about politics.
Just as American politics should be.
Now, I'm no expert. I'm no expert on metal and gears, but is the Armstrong fight the last fight of the game?
I believe this is the final boss.
Yes. He's main villain vibes.
What up, Mikey?
How many
welcome back.
Gone
thank you very much
fight.
for the Prime sub. I appreciate
this
it.
We just finished stage two, I suppose.
I believe that was stage two of the fight, kinda.
I see.
God, he looks like fucking Captain America from that one comic.
He has a dream.
He has a dream.
I know the one you're talking about, the one where his like shield is blocking his ass and he's like huge.
He's like enormous. Like from his back to the front of his chest is 4 times the length of his head.
He's built like a college football player in University of Texas.
He's built like Armstrong.
He's built like someone who played college ball.
Yeah. In Texas.
I was gonna say, that guy is actually famous for his really bad drawings.
Nice. Oh, he's gonna say the thing. I think.
Where every man is free to think, to act, for himself! Fuck all these lunatic lawyers and chicken shit bureaucrats!
The presidential debate is a lot more violent than I remember.
God, but could you imagine doing this to like Trump?
Yeah, Biden versus Trump like this.
Incredible.
America's disease.
There was like an 8-minute long YouTube video, but it was a guy that was just like reading in a funny voice reviews of different movies, and for this particular video it was Olympia Has Fallen, I believe, the movie where terrorists attack the White House and the president is like the action hero. And one of the reviews was like 1 star. It's like, what are you talking about? The president's in his mid-50s and physically fit and actually does stuff on a daily basis? Unrealistic. 1 star. I just like the idea. Like, could you imagine, like, however many years later they do a sequel to Metal Gear Rising Revengeance? And I know that we killed this guy, but like, imagine in an alternate reality, he becomes president and he has like a giant mech, and it's just fucking Metal Wolf Chaos 2.
That'd be amazing.
Could you imagine
if instead of getting into a giant mech, he just becomes a giant mech and becomes like 60 feet tall.
That'd be awesome. Fucking Power Rangers.
Yeah. That's the crossover we need, Metal Gear Power Rangers.
Honestly.
I want to put a sword on.
They already did a crossover with Street Fighter.
Yes. It was insane.
Do you think
the Red Ranger.
Do you think that at this point even Senator Armstrong's a little frustrated with how difficult it is to kill Raiden?
I'm gonna say Raiden has not broken not a bone. Broken a circuit. Put out that entire beatdown.
On that fucking chiseled body of his.
Body. That's not fair, though. The body was built chiseled.
Well, then you also got Armstrong over here.
Look at him. You gotta get that. Look at him. You gotta get that ass shot.
That build. Those glasses.
Those glutes.
Those thighs, dude. Look. His thigh, dude's caked up.
The individual thighs are thicker than his glutes, which is ridiculous.
It's amazing.
That's so good.
He'll rid this world of pointless wars. He's brushing them off. They're friends.
I beat the ever living shit out of you. Let's shake hands. I was wrong.
Put her there, pal.
You're not greedy.
End of the game. Roll credits.
Yeah, and then they were friends at the end.
Yeah. And they fell
Bite
in
his
love.
Neck. That shit insane.
Dude, who's out, Gobby? Out of your mind.
What are you talking? They shouldn't have done anything.
Oh, that's a good shot.
Oh, yeah.
Making the mother of all. Did this guy really think he could convince someone to be on his side? No. Like, I don't know. I guess he did, because he let himself get hit, right?
Yeah.
You've never been hungry. It's true.
But you did survive. They say hungry.
But you did survive. With your own two hands, you took back your life.
And now, I'll take yours.
The voice.
And now.
Are we gonna fist fight this sumbitch?
What happened to your voice, Jack? It's weird. It's kind of scaring me.
Wait, how do I?
Oh my god.
Defeat Armstrong.
Defeat Armstrong. We have 0.1% health.
Yeah, that's cool.
Raiden, do something.
Home team.
I couldn't parry.
Wait, are we gonna do the thing?
What the fuck?
Oh yeah, let's
Power
go!
Punch.
It is really yeah. Fun.
wait, are we gonna war this aura? Gun warrant?
Yeah!
Look at the trap in the can!
I'm seeing it with my own eyes, finally.
Yes.
Oba with a dent in his head. You did survive! Armstrong, you're a son of a bitch, you know that? I'm clicking so fucking fast, dude! Ah! I'm gonna cramp up my arm!
Max doing an aura on his fucking mouse. Study Yamasuke.
Armstrong, come on, dude!
Why won't you die?
Oh yeah.
Stay alive!
Money shot!
Oh, fucking, that's so gross.
Nanomachine, son! Response to physical trauma.
Why does it sound like rubber?
You can't hurt me, Jack!
He's just stretching balloons all over him.
That just touches glasses, he'll get annoyed.
Yeah.
All over his glasses.
Yeah, you smudge him.
Yeah, I was say just smudge his glasses a little bit.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh my god. Oh,
you, I don't know. Oh. You might have like microfiber like thumb pads or something, so it doesn't actually stain. Just
we interrupt Metal Gear Rising to bring you Shido from Persona 5. True, yeah. Shido did do that at the very end on the yacht. Yo, wait a minute.
Wait a second.
Is this how we
Hold
beat him?
On.
I don't remember this.
You not remember, Zach?
No, I don't.
No.
Die, you piece of shit!
No way.
Holy shit, he was dented into the floor.
No, go back, Galactic, a monkey.
Hey Armstrong, why did you build that giant spider bot if you could just do this?
Yeah.
Cause robots are fucking cool.
Ah! Oh, Blade Wolf.
Wolf. Begin playback. 2 years I've been working towards this. And on the last day, Blondie has me doubting the whole thing.
I don't want to ruin the emotional impact of the moment, but that'd be hilarious if it was like begin playback, and within like a split second of the audio starting, fucking Armstrong took a rock, just sailed it clean through Blade Wolf's head, and he died. Like enough of that.
Anyways,
if I die here, the lock on my blade will disable after a couple hours. What happens after that is up to you, Wolfie.
Huh. Even dead, that guy's a pain in my ass.
And with a lot of ass.
Oh, yeah.
You think
oh, yeah. That's a lot of ass. Oh, yeah. So master. Much ass.
You think that little sword could save your master?
But make no mistake.
Maybe if it's a heated blade instead of a frequency blade, it'll work.
I'm finished with him.
Like a hot butter tonight.
Begin playback, cut to the foxes versus dogs to bait.
Oh no!
That would actually be a pretty good meme. I would just like, begin playback, and then just anything.
Yeah.
Here would violate that directive.
That's a good boy.
However, Raiden came to my aid.
You know what I want to know is where is the caveman?
When Samuel fell, data analysis was inconclusive. But that has changed. I have established
so if Armstrong were to win this, would he stay this beefed up forever? Or would he eventually, like, shrink back down?
You think it would deflate?
Yeah, I'm just thinking about it because, like, the only reason he's, like, this swole was because he absorbed the energy from the giant robot, right?
I think yeah. The nanomachines can, like, I don't know, continue it.
Zach, do you think this form is off-putting to the average American by any chance?
I don't know. Like, I wonder if it would be. Like, assuming he had, like, a well-fitting suit or whatever, if the dude was clearly fucking enormous and he went on live TV to be like, hey, vote for me as your next president, I wonder if people would be like, no.
Vote for me and you'll also look like this.
We had Schwarzenegger as governor.
Mikey's right. After a little bit of time, Armstrong just deflates like SpongeBob's anchor arms.
I love that. Oh, now he's taking off his glasses. Darn it, his only weakness.
This really does look like Noah.
Let's dance.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that looks like it's gonna hurt. Never mind.
Yeah, give me okay. A. Like, why are
he's
we.
He's got 200%.
Why are we spinning around? I need a parry. There you go, like that. I mean, we are hurting him. Dude, he has 200% health! Holy shit!
Yes,
he is beefy.
Ow. Oof. Fucking oof, dude.
Ow. Any single hit is just gonna hurt. Oh,
Debbie?
My bones. That's all out.
My bones!
That was my bad. I didn't realize that was gonna be like a giant AoE. I futilely went, Steppy! What? It tracks!
Oh my, he curves that shit? Okay.
That doesn't make any sense. Fuck that.
I expect nothing else from the man who played ball.
Who played college ball at university attack.
Oh, this is...
but it was a yellow attack. I thought maybe I could hit him out of it. Because you can do that to the gorillas and stuff.
Oh, I mean,
can
how
we not
this
just like counter this? It's a red flash. I guess we don't need to.
That's wrong.
Because you can always just steppy.
Yeah. This one's red. For some reason.
Because it's a different attack. Okay. Oh my god!
Because it's fire.
Armstrong! Jesus Christ! Calm the fuck down! Oh, he did the gorilla charge!
He did.
Damn, his arms be
what
strong.
What the fuck is happening? I'm gonna stay away from you for a little bit.
I need to learn what you do.
You cool
sir.
Down.
Holy crap!
This
could be rough. What do you mean parry? I think we have to get closer to him. I can't parry the projectile.
Yeah, what are you parrying? Fire?
Yeah. Yes. I mean, to be fair, we parried lasers before, but...
What?
Him.
Jesus,
I think it's just going to be safer in general to just... Steppy out of that.
No, just get up to him. Do it right now. Get up to him.
All right.
Okay, that was my pet. I can parry it. We just need to be closer.
I don't know about that.
We can parry it. We parried it before. We parried worse.
Did you?
Ooh. Here you go. Jesus, man.
Oh.
He's fine.
Oh.
Ripper mode
again.
Or not.
Okay.
I don't, because like I look at how big the AoE is, and I don't think we can steppy out of it like fast enough for when he does it. I think we need to hit him out of it.
All right, we could certainly
get in
try
there.
That.
I'll get it eventually, I promise.
What the fuck? You hit him out of that.
Oh, I didn't hit him out of that one. Ooh. Come on, Armstrong. Punch me.
Okay.
Not like, no, that wasn't a punch. That was a kick. I said, punch me. Do it again, but punch me this time.
Punch.
No, oh my god.
Jesus. Dude.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Man, this is the final boss.
Sure is.
This is gonna hurt.
Yeah. No way.
No healing because they do like three boss fights back to back to back. Get it close. Close. Yeah, you like that run?
You
or did you steppy?
I don't think we parried that. I think we just
didn't. Yeah,
no,
we just stayed
I thought
away
I parried
from
it.
You're gonna hit the lot, yeah. Okay. I think Lawrence just walked around.
Yes.
Hey man.
The good old Dark Souls maneuver.
Just oh, just walking slightly to the left or right.
Yeah.
Ow, dude.
This is the farthest you guys gotten right now, though.
Nope.
Oh, that's a line.
Come on. There you go.
Get his ass. Now run away.
Oh.
That's a line.
Steppy that way. There you go.
Yeah. What
oh,
the fuck?
Hey. Look at his stupid face. Oh!
Okay, it was very specific.
I think Lawrence and I thought the exact same thing. I thought it was just going to be like in the monsoon fight.
Yeah, I was like, this is going to be easy as shit. No.
I just want to parry him. Come on,
we're
I can do
parrying.
It. I can do it, boss.
No, God, you have
Platypus.
If I
boss,
learn
how,
if I
there.
Learn his parry timings, this will be a lot easier.
I download his moveset.
He's downloaded!
He's downloaded!
Oh, I love that clip. Dude, stop it with the AoE! Ooh. Please! Nice, man.
2.5.
Ooh. Knocked him out of that. Camera, please, I need you to work with us.
Yeah, I bet this wouldn't happen if you guys played college ball.
You're right. That's a requirement.
Yeah.
You know, the game where it's like basketball, instead of a basketball, you play with an entire college building.
Yeah,
college ball.
That's why I'm from so strong, because you play college ball, not wimpy-ass basketball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Football.
That too.
the timing.
I can do it.
You don't have to do it though.
I want to.
You could just walk away.
But it'd be way cooler. I just want to keep hitting you. The thing gives me so much health. Yeah, do like that. Ooh. You want Steffi? Like... There. Oh, what?
Oh, what the
turned around.
Goodbye.
He's so maneuverable.
Oh.
Does this count? It counts.
He was leaving. He was done.
He's done.
I want to parry you.
We're not.
I want to parry you. Oh, it's this one. Lords.
Well.
Try to dodge into the other one, but you step from one line to another line.
So, Adrian, how's Project Zomboid going?
Well, I was zoomed out really, really far. My character got bit in the shirt. Thankfully, not the front.
No! Hit bit in the shirt?
I'm wearing like four layers of shirt to protect myself, and I got bit in one of them.
And you're so warm.
In Project Zomboid, the more clothing you wear, the less likely zombie teeth will penetrate your skin and kill you. Which, you know, that's fine. I think it makes sense.
Oh my god,
he's gonna do it a second time. Oh.
Dude, he's way higher health than he was last time we did this.
It's cool. We know how to get through this phase.
Flash him.
Oh! Wow. What have we learned?
I heard the beep beep and I was like, alright, we're good. What if we parried him though?
What did happen?
Hear me out.
Ooh. Oh, that's good.
Ooh, oh, that was an okay Steppy. That's the big, that's the lines. Yeah.
I ain't gonna charge you.
I was getting ready to
Language,
pull out a lock to
you're a senator.
He's getting canceled for sure.
Yeah.
Senator Armstrong got canceled on Twitter.com.
Yeah.
Do it again. Yeah.
Jacks are canceling me.
Oh my god, he's doing this multiple times.
Armstrong is over, party. I don't even understand why.
We're not so different, you and I. Remember that time you wore a sombrero for no reason?
Remember when we both got canceled?
What the hell?
I can't do anything about that one.
Yeah, I don't know. That one's the tricky
it's
one.
It's a tough fight. Did you know that the final boss of Metal Gear Rising Revengeance would be tough?
Exactly.
Who knew?
You know that Nier Automata.
there was a thing I saw on Twitter which was like, hey, post your inside jokes and we'll rate them based on whether or not they're funny out of context. And I was really man. Tempted to do the Nier Automata copypasta. I don't know. But...
Hi.
Dude.
He called you a little shit.
Are you a little shit, Zach, or a big shit?
I'm pretty hard to flush down the toilet, I think.
Now's your chance to be a big shit.
See? You just let me fucking hit the man.
Be the big
instead
shit.
Instead of wanting to dodge all the time like a coward.
Be the bigger shit.
Be the bigger shit. Yeah, 2. Walk away, be the big walk away, take the bigger shit.
Take the bigger shit.
Turn the other shit.
Could you imagine if this entire boss fight took the rest of the time we what the fuck happened? What happened? I didn't even click.
I was
didn't enter the thing.
He just threw it at us in real time, and then we died. Yeah,
it's really funny thinking about it in real time. Because he just jumped. Bam! He just jumped up there.
His attacks are so quick,
that the parry timing that the game has been teaching me so far is too slow.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, shame. It's like this is the parry timing that I was trying to do back when we first did Blade Wolf, that then the game was like, oh, by the way, that's wrong.
You can't even jerk him off to stun him.
Yeah.
Why can't we? Track beam.
They don't even have jerked him off to stun him.
That's right.
They don't even have dental. We're jerking him off.
Oh, man.
They can't even jerk him off.
Sag.
Honestly.
How are you feeling, Lawrence?
We haven't died this much since Blade Wolf in the beginning of the game.
It's almost like the game has decided to completely change its core mechanic. You know what I mean? Deppy. That's fine? Oh, no. Oh, never mind. He just does it into too. An AoE immediately. That's fair. Get in there, man. Fuck this guy. Fuck him up.
Trust me, we're trying.
Unfollowed. I was okay when I learned he played college ball, but now that he wants to destroy America, don't know.
He wants to improve America. With war and destruction.
Yeah, in his own words, he'll make America great again.
Yeah.
Steppy. That's fine. Nope. Lawrence!
That's fine.
It's fine.
Hey, good luck,
we're below 150. All right, let's see if we can do it this time.
No real time, please. Oh, there's another one.
You gotta move the camera.
This can't be happening.
I thought it was good on a single camera.
Nope, was not. That's okay. Let's get back there again. We have an hour and a half to do this. Nope. Yes.
Oh, he smacked us. All right. Ooh. Okay. This is not a good run. Not a good run at all.
What happened? What is going on? Raiden, answer me. Raiden.
See, now this would be the perfect time to bring up, like, banter about, like, the Olympics or whatever. Not during, like, the middle of a cutscene.
Well, you guys are talking usually during it. Perry! No, Lawrence! Zach! And then
well, this is because we need time. We just need practice.
We need time.
Wait, was that the big pillar? How am I supposed to recognize the difference between that one and the one where he puts the lines on the ground? They look exactly the fucking same.
There's extra ground effects with the lines. Ooh, this one we can't see, though.
What's your guys' go-to protagonist anime outfit of the clothes you own right now?
I wear one outfit every day like an NPC.
It's a...
You know the... Remember how on Halloween I said I was dressing up as Brian and I got a really expensive jacket for it?
Yeah. Oh, the green one?
Yeah, it's that jacket.
Nice.
Mine is a black trench coat with a red scarf.
You own that?
Black trench coat with a red scarf?
Yeah.
Oh,
what the fuck?
I know you own a trench coat.
It was cold in winter.
Ah, shit! I want to see you wear that. That sounds sick as fuck.
How about you, Zach? What's your go-to?
Lauren's got drip.
Either my Goonies t-shirt or my Night in the Woods t-shirt with either blue jeans or any shorts.
That's your anime look?
I don't have any other look.
Oh. Hey, don't you have a Team Rocket team shirt? That's anime.
I don't have that t-shirt anymore, actually, because it had a bunch of holes in it. I have that hoodie. Does that count? Can I wear that hoodie and that'd be my anime look?
I guess, if your look is anime grunt.
The anime pro tag look.
If my look wasn't anime grunt, why would I own the hoodie? You know what I mean?
To disguise
yourself.
I'm okay
being a Team Rocket grunt.
Team Rocket.
You get paid. What the fuck, dude? Man, this fight's hard. You're going down. It's like such a spike in difficulty compared to like, see like, I think we have to hit him out of that. Cause I think that's like a full screen AOE that he does. Either that or but you gotta like... back up twice real fucking quick.
Ooh, that one was fast.
Answer me! Ride it! Give it!
When we parry him, does he take damage?
Absolutely not. Oh, damn it, dude.
You have a Z. Why not use your Z?
Oh, now you want to dodge.
Well, no, because you're the one that's not letting me parry the thing. So I'm asking, why are we just running instead of using the Z?
Because I'm going left and right, my man.
No!
Oh, my God. We can't see.
I can't see shit. Die, you little shit! Die, you little shit! Die, you little shit! Stop!
He's stuck in a loop.
What's wrong?
Ah.
Come on, buddy, answer me!
I'm going to smash my head against the table.
No, no! Don't that. You're gonna turn off your computer.
I'm gonna put a pencil vertically on the table and then just shove it through my eye.
Oh, immediately! Like that eye.
Lawrence, stop sidestepping that. Step back.
It's literally choosing to sidestep. Let's do ripper mode. Let's see if that gives us any luck.
Let's see if that gives us any luck. No, we're just gonna get hit by a lot.
Who's to say?
Yeah, that's not me pressing left or right. I'm just full on backwards.
Well, are you holding back?
What the fuck?
What the fuck?
Whoa, this is new. Oh, he knocked it out of your hand. Oh, get his ass.
Okay,
yeah.
Get his ass.
Break his fucking ribs. Holy shit.
Holy shit.
Wait, how did this happen?
What did you do?
I don't know. I parried his charge, I think. Where's our blade?
It was behind us, I think.
Lauren, oh,
there it is. Wait, can we not?
F! There was a button prompt that came out and said F. Pick it up. Thank you.
Good thing we're in the Mariachi form. Here we go.
Okay, so keep in mind, when he does the charge instead of steppy, we should parry. We have 0.1% health.
It's fine.
Okay.
Good lord.
Him.
Oh yeah, dude!
In the face.
Please let that.
That
be
was only 20% of his health. Fuck you, dude. We have 0.1 health left. One.
Back point, please.
Oh, there's a health pack. Grab it! Grab it! Grab it! Grab it! Grab it! Yeah.
Oh,
there's
God.
Another one. Grab
there's
it! Grab it quick! Grab it quick! Grab it quick! Or it's just steppy or something, I don't know. It's gotta be here. There it is! You got it!
Oh, that's a steppy. Holy
well, that was
shit.
I was gonna try to parry that, pack. But I think we both had
it
the right.
Yellow.
What the fuck? I think
what
we both
fuck?
Had the right idea. I don't know what's
what
happening.
The...
He's
oh,
like.
That's
be...
a...
He's become like an Oni.
Hold on, no, stop hitting him! Okay.
Stop hitting him?
I don't know, it looked like a target thing? Okay,
I definitely do not think it was a target thing.
This is how we work.
Oh, it punched its... Oh, it's the same thing again! It maybe?
Get his ass. Maybe.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God. It's so cool. Dude, he's not even below 100%, please.
He did college professional wrestling, you know?
He rolled it.
He's powering up.
Right,
what saying?
Oh, we get health packs. Oh, that's nice. Now,
did you lose your sword?
Hit E to unlock.
Yeah, they did.
So we can look around. It's over there.
It's behind.
Oh. Oh, come on.
No, he's pushing you there. He's helping you out.
All right, now toss us exactly
there. With a low cost
over
of
there.
70%
grab
of your
it.
Health, he'll get you slightly
ninja
closer
run,
to your sword.
Ninja run, Lawrence! We got the ninja! It's literally a run! All right, hit... We gotta hit E. Let's
holy
go.
Shit.
Let's go.
How did they fucking kill out? I'm carefully maneuvering through the lines.
Did you lose your sword again? Okay, there you go.
No, you got it back.
Yeah. Oh, keep going again.
Oh, I almost said it's not a cute one. You guys remember Kangaroo Jack, the live action one?
I don't remember that, Jack.
What?
Oh, he's regenerating health, Lawrence!
Oh, we have to hit him.
I was gonna say, it's green, he's healing.
Let's do that. I think that's...
So it's blade mode to bring him out, I guess, because he grabs the thing. Okay.
Yeah.
So no wonder he was a... So... Yeah, okay. Alright, alright.
But still,
okay. That's still very bad. We take a lot of damage.
Yeah, we still take hits from that.
There's gotta be a way to do that without taking damage.
I think we can parry him in the green mode. I think we can.
Did you guys eat kangaroo?
I've never eaten kangaroo.
It depends if kangaroo is or not.
Oh, would I?
Yeah, would you?
What's the kangaroo some sort of a criminal?
I mean, it's Australia, of course. It was...
Oh, really?
Dude, I got to... I was able to imply that a place in my D&D game was like unlawful
that, dude,
and like
so
crazy
stupid.
And upside down just because then, oh yeah, there's kangaroos there.
That's good.
God, I'm just gonna be the whole fucking fight. It's so fucking
back to 200.
Jesus Christ, dude.
Jesus Christ.
I love you, is the word's name.
Oh. Well, yeah, speaking of that, good reading, because every Thursday at the school I work at, we do, like, reading. We just do a period of reading. And I found out there's, like, 4 comic books in the teacher's shelf that are all specifically about a high school age lesbian. So different books.
What?
And they're about different lesbians, but they all have the same basic premise of like, yeah, this girl is my high school and she's also a lesbian.
Ooh, they're comic books?
Yeah, comics. They're like one-offs.
What's happening?
Huh.
What is going on?
They're not like they're not like superhero like thin tall things. They look more like manga where they're dense and like brick-like, but they're completely American in English and writing and all that.
Dense and brick-like is my body description on my driver's license.
Dense and brick-like is how I describe my shit.
Ew.
Actually, that's how we have a kid that we're fostering, and that's what his just. Normal people poop like a tube. His is like a potato. It's clogging and frustrating because I have to unclog it.
I am sorry.
It's astonishing.
Oh, we're here already.
That's a skill.
They look painful.
Exactly why it's a skill.
Has anyone made a joke about how big Armstrong's forehead is?
Yes.
On stream?
Yes.
Yeah.
Get his head.
The joke?
Get his ass. Well, not really a joke, I guess. Bobora saying like when this originally came out, there was a kid in our school who looked very similar, and that was, I talked about it. There you go. That was the bit. We talked about it.
Well, it doesn't sound like you made a proper joke out of it, so.
What do I time showing? Lawrence, what are you doing?
I'm trying to move where the camera ain't. What are you doing?
Because we have to. Because if you use the blade mode on him, he's just gonna counter us and it's gonna hurt.
As opposed to stopping him from healing and still getting hurt.
Stop. When I hit him, if you stop moving for a second, I can parry his immediate punch back. That's what I'm saying. I'm trying to get practice doing that. But every time I go to hit, immediately we're moving to the side. And I'm like, I can't do this. So, not yelling at you specifically, but that is what I would like to try. Because if we do the blade mode and strike him, he's doing 20% to us no matter what. I would rather try to get the parry down so we don't take the 20% for free. Are we in agreement?
Pause. All right, unpause.
Okay. 3, 2, 1. Holy fuck!
Cliff take off on Armstrong's forehead.
Oh, that was awesome!
What the fuck?
I don't know what this is! Oh, it's one of these again. F.
Oh.
What?
Liver shot. Liver shot. Liver shot. Liver shot.
Did we already do the cutting part? Did that already happen? It's right. Yeah, it's directly behind us. Oh, and there's health over there. F.
Oh.
And then there's health to our left. Right there. Yeah. Oh. Armstrong, you fool. No, this is bad. I don't know how to deal with that one.
Are you not? Okay. Oh, did the health thing apply automatically?
Wait, did it not stop him?
Doesn't look like it's stopping him.
Okay, never mind. Blade mode then. Oh. Can I at least get some praise for the fucking parry timing? I thought that would be the thing. Like, how are we supposed to stop that? Is that just supposed to, like...
I don't know. Oh, that's against the wall. It's cool. We got health.
we got two more health packs, which is nice. Oh, back!
Nobody does that.
Oh, I see. It says you have to go specifically behind him when he's healing.
Oh, because that's where all the light's coming from.
Okay.
If you do it from the front or side, it'll auto counter you.
Okay.
So you gotta stab in the back.
I think that's relatively fair.
Yeah, you have to be all cowardly and craven like a coward.
So we can steppy. You can steppy through him, I believe, right? If you forward steppy.
I guess so.
No, I'm mad. I know you've been cleaving my flesh apart like butter, but now I'm
really
mad.
For 20 minutes.
I have returned.
Welcome back.
Thanks. Got
Aren't
it?
You heading out soon?
Yes, I
got it.
True, but there was someone sneaking around my
got
house.
It.
Did you treat
got
him
it.
Like a proper burglar and give him the burglar welcome?
Yeah, I did.
The burglary welcome.
Yeah, it's the one where you shoot him.
Yeah, so I gotta escape before the police arrive.
So,
but they burgled your home.
Oh, I was gonna say, I don't know the. So. I don't know if California has the castle rule.
The what?
Oh, the castle self-defense clause.
Oh no! Well, California has a lot of weird rules.
California has a lot of weird people in it, like the burglar who is definitely right. Not me.
It's behind us.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
Directly behind us.
You go back in the stream clip and you hear me like while you're
gonna
gone.
I charge. Steppy.
Like, oh, do this. Man.
Yeah.
Ignore
yeah.
the fact that I'm running really, really fast.
Right.
There's
cool.
two health packs on
health.
The floor, which is kind of difficult, actually. He's doing it again.
Oh, boy.
Okay, there's one more
it's
in front
cool.
of us.
We got one.
Get it. Did you get
hey,
it?
Can you quiet
right
stream
there.
So I can sneak around Grant's house easily?
Ooh, that was bad timing on my part.
He just decked you. I mean, he really clobbered you.
Is that Pillar of Flame? That is Pillar of Flame.
He really pounded you in the schnoz.
Right.
Oh,
there
it's literally a target. Wow, okay.
There you go. I knew there was a target somewhere.
Yeah, you just have to be craven about it. Like the spy from Game Brothers 2.
Oh.
I want to... Now
what
that one,
John
I still
Cena?
Don't know how to do. I still feel like we need to hit him out of it. Oh, maybe it's a blade mode thing.
Maybe?
I don't want to jinx it, but he's already pretty low. It's almost like letting him knock it 150% is a good idea.
Yeah. He's good. Again? Okay.
Don't fuck it up.
If we do this correctly, wouldn't it kill him? Because it's 20%?
It'll probably come around to one.
Holy fuck!
Oh my god.
Up.
I don't know what that was about.
Let's dodge! Drayden! Why? It's cool, we got plenty of health.
Mesh! Yes!
I mashed
nice.
That shit.
And we just picked up the blade.
The fear of, like, I don't want to do this again. Ooh, do it again, bitch!
I'm running it back.
Run it back.
I'm trying not to move the reticle at all, so that way... We're okay. X.
Oh,
oh
yeah.
He's at 11% though.
He's gonna bleed out.
It'll
the
probably
rest.
Bring him down to like a very low percent. We have to do like a QTE to finish him.
or you aura him.
Aura.
God, he's so mad. Wait, our sword's in him.
Yeah, it sure
Brandon,
is.
You should have pulled it out. Son. Nice. Yeah, like that.
Oh, I think we gotta repeatedly hit that spot. Yeah!
Oh.
Pull that shit out.
God, the fact that we did this in the mariachi uniform is
Well done, Jack.
You're president now.
Does it, yeah, but I was saying, does this mean that Raiden is now the senator?
Yeah.
Yes.
That's a different you and I. You were wearing a sombrero a second ago. I did blackface in college.
Jesus.
Guaranteed status quo in for a while longer, at least. War.
Remember how Justin Trudeau did that and literally no one cared?
That's not very true. A lot of the Canadian public very much disliked it. So.
I mean, yeah, but he's still fucking prime senator or whatever.
Well, it's a little
he's
different.
The prime directive.
Just because he, I mean, in theory, just because he made, I don't know, a couple mistakes when he was younger doesn't mean that he's not trying to do good stuff now. And it's not like there's really a better alternative, since the rest of the candidates that would replace him as prime minister are all assholes.
Did you do blackface, Zach?
Huh?
Zach did blackface and college.
Oh no.
It was definitely not just him being quietly in a dark room and me mistaking him for wearing that. No, it was definitely him wearing blackface.
Squinting my eyes because I couldn't
me
see
squinting my eyes and thinking, yeah.
Holy crap,
you know,
that's a ridiculous
lock?
Heart.
I saw with my dark vision that I have, my night sense.
No, his gains.
Oh,
his
dude, he's gains. Got rebar sticking out of him.
Oh, get that out.
Yeah. No, that's his gains.
His gains. Yeah, just stick rebar in your veins.
Yeah.
Your veins and gains.
And I.
See? Deep down, we're kindred spirits, you and I.
You and I, we're not so different. You were wearing a sombrero a second ago.
Red
and
eyes,
there is photographic evidence of me mauling children with my bare hands.
We're not so different.
Dude, there's no way that's gonna be. Wow, Billy! That's way better than I would have anticipated, actually.
We're not so different. You were wearing a sombrero, and I blew up Malaysia.
I blew up Malaysia.
I like the implication that those are even remotely similar. We got so in the first phase of the boss fight, we got a C. Second phase, we got a C. Third phase, a B.
A B. Let's go.
Hot dog, dude, that was rough. High frequency Muramasa blade.
Murasama,
sorry. Is that Jetstream Sam's weapon?
Yeah, I think that's Sam's.
Robots are fucking real. There was a giant one. Have you seen this shit?
Yeah.
MG trade, Metal Gear trade is down.
In other news, Disney farted and decimated our stock trade, so we're going out of business now.
Yeah. Just
also, the cyborg is our senator. He wanted to fight for the senator.
Tragic news today. Our senator lost in a really cool robot fight, so now he's dead. Anyways.
Yeah. Anyways.
Anyways, our vice senator, Blarmstrong.
Blarmstrong, it's just Armstrong, but in like a mustache.
Yeah, Groucho Marx glasses.
It's just Armstrong, but slightly larger.
Wide strong.
According to our camera feed, Senator Armstrong was able to deck Raiden like 50 times before Raiden took one shot off of him.
For whatever reason,
Raiden died
had,
like so many times.
And for whatever reason, Raiden had two voices that were arguing with each other. But then they were able to come together and beat Armstrong.
Then they were able to come.
Then they were able to come together.
To come.
I guess the world's first cyborg staffing firm is officially open for business.
We are certified for construction and long-term nursing care, but this is just the beginning. The potential for new roles cyborgs can play is limitless.
And we're sure this isn't child labor?
Like senators, perhaps.
Yes.
Arrest when they come of age. And it's strictly voluntary, you know.
Have we made a joke about how big this guy's forehead is?
Oh, he's got the coffee.
Donations alone would not even cover their maintenance.
Peter Popoff.
Peter Parker. Peter Popoff.
Peter Parker. Guys, look, it's Peter.
Do you know what? These Peter Popoff Parker.
No.
Yeah, that's Peter Parker right there. Them to the streets, or he fused with J. Jonah Jameson.
I want pictures of me on my desk tomorrow.
On my OnlyFans.
On my OnlyFans. Listen,
Listen,
I need your help taking pictures of the exclusive exotic angles of myself for my OnlyFans. I can't take them myself. I'm not that flexible anymore. Ever since I fused with J.J. Jameson and lost half my Spider-Man DNA.
Oh no.
Oh, the doctor's real name is William Voight.
Voight.
It says it above his name.
Oh, dude, can I really tell a story from work?
What's up?
There was we were teaching the kids how to do like PEMDAS, like parentheses, exponent, etc., etc., right?
Yeah.
And one of the kids was making fun of me for saying it weirdly because apparently he said a PEMDAS and I said PEMDIS because I was not putting effort into saying it. And he was like, "Why are you saying like that? It's PEMDAS." And I was like, "It's PEMDIS." And then I had to click my brain, and it took me every fiber of restraint not to tell this kid, "Come to stick fit in your mouth, idiot. Get old." instead I asked him, "Pemdis Mathesian Sport?" And then he was like, "Leave. I don't want you anymore, leave. I don't want your help anymore."
Pemdis D's nuts.
Boo. Pemdis nuts. Anyway. That was the story. I thought it was funny because it's one of the only times that something math related has been funny in my life.
You should have like choke slammed him into a table. Through a table.
I could not. This kid weighed like 150 pounds in middle school.
150 pounds now.
Right?
What the heck?
You're feeding something different to these middle schoolers. It's called more food.
I know. It's called morphine.
It's called morphine. They're high all the time. I would believe it. There's this one kid we have who's new who just constantly gets up from his desk and starts dancing apropos nothing. Like he just starts, he'll get up, start dancing, and then sit down. Well, he actually won't just sit down. Just get up and start dancing and stand at his desk instead and dance and like flip off teachers or whatever. Super annoying. Yeah,
I don't know about that. Maybe he's actually a hero.
He could be dancing in the middle of class, distracting everyone.
Yes.
Yeah, he could be.
This kid is one of those kids who will constantly go to do something without telling anyone what he's doing, and then get mad at everyone for not knowing what he's doing.
All right, guys, I'm gonna take a shit. Oh, the game over.
Is that the high frequency sword?
That is the high frequency blade. Yes.
I wish they had like five different voice
Clinton
actors.
Oh, Clinton Flynn, thank you. And all you other voice actors.
Bill Lamar was Kevin?
Scientist Benito Martinez.
It is quite a short
game.
Khalifa
Old John? What kind of last name is that? Sorry, what were you saying? I was just astounded by that last name, Old John.
Old John.
No, I was just gonna say, like, when you think about it, I can see one of the reasons why this game didn't necessarily sell super well, because it is quite short, given the fact that when this came out, it was $60. Oof. You know? Now, it does have replay value in that you're supposed to do an entirely different playthrough with each of the special weapons.
I guess.
Well, because I mean, each of the special weapons, like the pole arm and the Psy and Sundowner's like scissor blades or whatever, they all have their own unique moveset. So if you're into that sort of thing, that's all cool. But if you're not into that sort of thing, this would be $60 for like what, 9 hours of play?
Roughly? I was gonna say that kind of assumes that. You're like, all right, I play this game wielding this cool sword, me ninja. Now I play this game using hands.
But I'm not gonna lie though, the pole arm moveset is pretty cool. You can do fucking insect glaive like pole vaulting shit over enemies. It's pretty cool.
And then
yeah, but it's hands as opposed to a sword. A
tin can and a string.
That's my favorite weapon.
Yeah.
How would you wield a tin can and a string if it was given to you and there's a ninja
like
in front of you that's trying to kill you?
Yeah, swing it around by the string.
Oh, all right, I see.
Because the tin can on a string has two tin cans, right? I would use one of them.
I was just thinking one.
Yeah, just one.
Well, let's assume for the sake of the thing I'm about to say that there's two. I would use it like that Japanese like chain with a hook on the end of it weapon or whatever that you see in movies. I would use it like that for the most part. But then if I got it to like wrap around, like I would try to get it to wrap around like my opponent's head, and then I would just grab my tin can and just go, ah!
Yeah, and then the string would snap.
Well, that's not
it's
really
just
my
like
fault,
regular ass string.
I was gonna say, if it was upgraded, you have to go to a blacksmith for that, but.
Sounds like the game designer's fault.
Supervising what? Director, Hideo Kojima.
The man
what was that
himself.
One? Let's revisit something. What was the bit where we were like, don't get greedy? Because I've forgotten what happened literally hours ago in this stream.
Don't get greedy.
Don't get greedy?
Don't get cocky, kid.
Wasn't that like a catchphrase of something where it's like, don't get greedy? Don't.
Was it? I don't know.
It was catchphrase of a company, I think, was the bit.
Of a company.
That should be Nintendo's catchphrase, don't be greedy.
Oh, yeah. Because we were discussing, I don't think that was earlier today. I think that was yesterday, Adrian. Because we were talking about Pokemon Legends Arceus.
Right.
And we were talking about how, like, the gameplay changes they made were really good and seems like a really positive change for the, like, the franchise moving forward. But then, like, the environment design sucks ass. And so I don't remember if it was you or me went like, well, don't get greedy. And then Saba starts cackling and she goes, what is that the catchphrase for the game? Pokemon Legends Arceus, don't get greedy.
Don't get greedy.
and then we started taking that to like extremes. It was pretty good.
Yeah, as I say, that's Nintendo's new catchphrase, don't get greedy.
Because like Pokemon doesn't have the gotta catch them all slogan anymore. So it should be Pokemon, don't get greedy.
Pokemon, it's catch Pokemon. The ones we let you catch.
Pokemon, you'll buy it.
That should be the catchphrase. You'll buy it.
All right, I got to get going. Goodbye, everyone. Right,
goodbye. I remember there was some product. I don't remember what product was at all. But I remember there was some product, and someone posted like, man, I sure do love the enthusiasm on these guys. And then the product's slogan was like, you'll say it's good.
Well, bold.
Very ambitious.
A bold tactic for sure.
Good job, guitars.
Oh, I think it was for a cookie, if I remember correctly. It was like this foreign like cookie shaped like a little bear in a costume. It was like the cookie. You'll say it's good.
A soul can't be cut.
Rules of nature. I'm the old master now.
What's the first rule of nature, Zach?
Don't talk about it.
Okay, what's the second rule of nature?
Remember the first rule.
What's the third rule of nature?
I before E, except after C.
Or when ending in way as a neighbor or hey, or way, whatever. Isn't there like another verse to that?
I don't know, man. English is too amalgamated to actually have rules like that. So the fact that they made like lyrical idioms like that make no sense to me.
I will say, I apparently learned that English has more synonyms by far than any other language.
Yes, by an enormous factor, yeah.
Which is good and bad. It's bad for people trying to learn it, but it does make it a very artistically freeing language.
I never realized that.
One of the critiques of there being so many like similes or whatever, synonyms rather, in English is that it's very hard to convey like emotional nuance or like emotional context via text, because since all the words technically mean the same, the emotional weight of the word depends on like the individual's context. You know what I mean? Like the difference between beautiful and gorgeous. Like technically there's no difference there, except most people would be able to identify something. Whereas like, I'm trying to remember, I think it's like traditional Chinese. They have like six very specific words for beautiful, depending on your relationship to the thing that you're describing as beautiful.
Oh, good. So,
I don't know. It's a double-edged sword.
It's a sword that I have to pry out of my cold, dead hand because I've super glued my hands to it.
You cost them a lot of money, huh? Not to mention killing their funding. Literally. Now, the breathtaking program is finished, but the larger company is not, I'm afraid.
World Marshal.
PMCs are in demand once again.
I just found the Origins of Iconic Images Twitter page. It's really good.
Causes they don't believe in.
The first image, the most recent one they posted on their page, is the one where it's a sperm, where it's like, how long to reach the fallopian tubes? To reply is, still a long way to go. We've only passed the tonsils.
But then, what will you do?
All right. Fight.
All right, Raiden. Whatever. I don't know. I don't get it.
I'm sure that means something for the fans.
Maybe. Well, because like, I'm not exactly sure, but that'd be really funny if this was like the last thing chronologically that occurred in the Metal Gear canon. That'd be really funny. All right.
He is evil,
well, that was that.
I think. There we go. Ooh. 5 hours.
So these are our ratings for the chapters.
You know what? That is passing.
Passing.
I wonder what word in the English language has the most C's.
I don't know. Completely normal, earning more than, okay. Completely normal, using only the high frequency blade as a weapon.
We are samurai.
Completely normal, hired difficulty despite being discovered by enemies 50 times. It's true. Every time there was an enemy, we just ran up to them and we're like, hey.
Yeah.
Jack the Ripper, cut your enemies at least 1,000 times using blade mode.
Nah, hell yeah, we did.
Definitely what happened. That's not really a word.
It's an obscure term for a lung disease.
Can you say it? Pneumotrichomycosis silicovolcanconiosis.
Pneumonultra microscopic silica volcano coniosis.
Let's see if I can spit that out. So it's pneumono.
Ultra.
Mono.
Ultra.
Ultra.
Microscopic.
Microscopic.
MIB. Men in boxes.
Silico.
Silico
volcano.
Lawrence, look.
Hey, they got the boxes.
Right, but they're posing like they're on a gravure magazine.
I love that.
Great. Because we are. Oh, you split it.
Ultra microscopic silico volcano coniosis. Why is it a volcano there though?
It's when you have a really small, cold, silicon-based volcano in you. And it's super, it's like ultra. It's a lot. You have a lot of them.
All right. So Lawrence.
New game with Jetstream and Blade Wolf, excuse you?
So those are the DLCs. Obviously he's not in chat anymore, but that one person, that one rando from however many hours ago, you weren't looking in chat, but they were like, they were like, hey, you play as Sam in the DLC. And I was like, shh, don't tell Lawrence. But yeah, so the first DLC is you get to play as Jetstream Sam, and the second DLC is you get to do a campaign as Blade Wolf.
Jetstream, I can understand.
They're different Blade campaigns Wolf? In the base game, though, right?
I believe each one of them has one new level, whereas the other ones are going, like, backwards through levels you've already done. But you do have, like, custom boss fights and stuff.
I was gonna say, it's not just the same campaign, but they treat Blade Wolf as Raiden. It's like awkwardly rig up all of Blade Wolf's animations to replace Raiden.
I would love that. Honestly, how jank that would be.
I think since we have like 45 minutes left of stream, I think we'll do a little bit of the beginning of Jetstream stuff, because I have not finished either of their campaigns. Despite having played this game a lot, I have never finished either of their campaigns, because Raiden, kind of straightforward. His gameplay, as you saw, mostly just depends on getting a parry and then just blade storming the shit out of somebody. Jetstream Sam is very Jetstream Sam is very specific with how his mechanics work. We'll see once we get in there. And then Blade Wolf is weird because, as Adrian kind of mentioned, Blade Wolf is cool. Like, he's a cool character and kind of a badass. But a lot of his missions, just once he gets detected, he'll just get shot and die. So it's a lot of stealth. It's a lot of actual stealth in the Blade Wolf part. So,
yo, let me in.
Also, Age, get that shit out of the audio.
Mountain Dew flavored Gerber baby food.
I was gonna say, that's a gamer baby. You don't want a gamer baby?
Gamer.
I don't know if I want to eat blue foods.
All right, Saba, tag out for me. I'm gonna head out. It's cool. See you guys later.
Okay.
All right. Peace.
Bye. You know, Lawrence, I remember yesterday I was talking about the fact that we said we were gonna talk before stream. Yes, I am so sorry.
Yes, and then you went hiking.
and then I got dragged hiking, and then, woof.
I see how it is.
I was gonna say, after this, we should talk. Oh man, I will let you know. At least there's karma that came back to me, because my legs are already starting to hurt in a way where I'm like, this is going to be painful tomorrow morning.
Oof. Oh, we can see all of the
glorious of thighs. Body. Ooh, he fast.
So he doesn't have jump, ninja though. Run, because he's not a ninja, he's a samurai.
Oh, you nerd, fast. You should have. Oh, man.
So you actually kind of have to do your platforming.
Gosh darn.
Though him not being able to grab a ledge doesn't really feel like a samurai-less thing.
Oh, you have two jumps! I didn't even know
that's
that.
That's why, okay. Okay,
That doesn't
that's
make a lot of sense.
Listen, samurais can double jump, not ninjas. I love his smirk.
So, I don't get it. I know we still think this guy's cool, right? But did we like him in terms
of,
like,
the narrative was trying to push the idea that he was honorable, which I guess is redeemable in some way.
I don't know. I don't think I felt that from him. Like, it felt like he was more or less just trying to mess with us the entire time.
Well, kinda, because he was trying to encourage Raiden to be, like, the best combatant Jesus that he Christ. Could be, or whatever. Some stupid garbage like that, you know.
Yeah, I agree. Stupid garbage.
That being said, might be too much analysis for such a game.
It's not as in-depth as that. Though I can say, or we may be able to say that maybe perhaps they were trying to be in-depth, Lawrence, and then we can be like, they just failed.
Are you sure about that? We are ninja cyborgs. Oh, just do them.
Hey, who says ninja cyborgs can't be in-depth or have depth?
All I'm saying is there might be some shenanigans. What the? Freaking crack. Oops.
So, did you read what it said about the taunt?
Yeah, taunt and they come attack you.
Right, but then when they're taunted, they take and deal double damage.
Oh man, that's all of them. Just the gang.
Forgot that this was in their building.
Cherry blossoms.
Yeah.
Shut up, Monsoon!
I take it you're not a fan?
No.
I like American stuff only.
They make me sick.
What an archetype.
Fancy pants. American?
Yes, I only like
yes, that's the archetype.
And large steaks.
There's only yeah, three things we Americans need.
A tractor to me.
We only need good beer, John Deere, and John 316 by me.
I need an eagle flying through an air as I ride my tractor sipping my beer.
They go from full blossom
oh, man.
To beer in a... Remember when we come through this area later and we chopped up these trees? These like ancient really? Cherry blossoms that were imported from Japan and we just chopped them up. We were fighting a bunch of dudes. Not beautiful,
not beautiful. I probably wasn't paying attention to it then. Blows, the flowers float away. But what a shame.
But someone like you and your big forehead doesn't understand that, sir.
Who are you talking being? About? Monsoon or the senator?
Or the doctor?
I mean, this guy has a big forehead because of maybe gadgets, right? The other guy just has a naturally big forehead.
Jetstream Sam. Oh, yeah, wait, was it Jetstream Sam's motorcycle that we stole?
Was that his motorcycle?
Or did what? He take his motorcycle
yeah,
too?
Yeah, because that's where we found it, remember?
Yeah.
Dude, it was Jetstream Sam's motorcycle. And then we killed him.
Same.
Oh my god, that's so funny. Oh yeah, it's the police.
Hey, let's bully this.
Let's
dude
bully this guy that's like
armor.
Mostly robot. See, he has that really cool scar that I like. The one where it's just like vertical down one of the eyes.
Well, yeah. What do we have here? Oh. This. We're just gonna... Oh yeah. Well, goodbye, sword.
He's using the sheep as a weapon.
Ow!
Sam! Sam, you're just a murderer!
I'm in.
Lawrence.
Hey, they messed with him, you know? He was minding his own business.
I'm gonna say, they could have left
and
us
like,
alone.
Why were they messing with him? He's not even black.
Oh my god, Zach.
What?
Please.
Oi,
everybody know that that's what they teach you on like day one of Police Academy.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. We are so
how about you
talented.
Just focus on your robot ninja cyborg samurai.
Dude, I love this charge
samurai
slash.
Oh
wait.
My god.
Yeah, that's why I included
whoa,
samurai.
Whoa, hold up.
At the end.
That's ranged.
Dude, hell
wait,
yeah,
hold
dude.
Up. Dash? Doing this. Okay. Dash again.
That's ranged.
Okay. So left click after a dash is a stinger. Right click after a dash is the charge into projectile. That's awesome.
Pretty nice.
Also, we don't have healing.
Oh,
hello.
You're really right.
That samurai bastard came this way. It's like, yeah, how do you know?
Oh, that before. Wasn't it.
Oof.
Thank you. I like how he stabs it first.
A guy who's all about his blade, you know?
Yeah. Oh, we can still use rocket launchers!
Shut up.
That's the only thing that matters. Hell yeah.
No,
can
drop.
You not F him?
I guess I can't.
We can't F him, unfortunately.
Shame.
Oh man, stop running.
So it's just the pattern's a little different because this one, because his heavy strike is the charge, you actually have to like time it relatively well.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh my god.
No healing.
He a heavier person than Raiden. I can feel.
They're different, you know.
I can feel it.
I can feel it. So in that case, maybe we should chill. Where's the other guy?
Just chill a little bit.
Yeah, we are surrounded by them. Oh,
relax.
Never mind.
F.
No melee.
What the fuck? Really? Wow, that's annoying.
Yeah, Sam is not a stealthy person, I guess. Oh, can we? Oh, shame.
He flipped out.
What a shame.
No, why'd you go down? We were losing alert.
It's cool.
We're on fire.
Oh, all right.
It's cool, he says. As we it's die cool. to a fucking blade thrower. We have 1.2% health!
So perfectly even.
Perfectly on balance.
Just as the samurai gods have intended. Man, his thighs are just really wide.
They're spiky.
Yeah. You're really pointy.
Holy shit! I cut the floor.
You
run!
You
no, stop, Lawrence. We're losing alert. Go to the right. Yeah. If we can get up, no, go up. Go up.
Jesus, fucking relax.
Why are you telling me to? Why? Wait, hold on. Why are you telling me to relax when you're just like running into enemies? We could just lose the alert and then be done.
You see me running backwards and to the right, like.
Frank.
like, oh, I know what I'm doing. Oh.
We're still on this.
You dead?
That's a lot of damage.
Really is. There's a lot of damage.
There's a chest.
I was trying.
Why
to
did
press
you taunt?
To see
if oh, because
best.
That's what AR mode was with Raiden.
Yep.
That's super fair. Whatever, like, let's just skip the chest. It's fine.
Like, oh, where is it?
That was easy.
Hi, dude.
That's so much damage so quickly. It's so stupid.
Oh, it's so wonderful. The power of the samurai! Oh shit.
I didn't even see this guy. What the fuck? The other guy's still alive!
Happening? He's still alive. He's still kicking. Literally.
Oh, I missed. What the
fuck? We just beheaded him instead.
Such a brutal cut.
We can't.
B. Great.
B.
Well, what do we have here? Maybe I should give it a try.
Yeah, maybe you should. Oh.
Wait, are we gonna do it?
Oh. Guess so.
Okay.
What the fuck?
Oh, maybe these are combat VR missions as opposed to Raiden, which is like platforming and combat? There you go, that's a double F.
There you go.
Perfect.
Ah. Ooh, but
it'll be fine.
That dude.
Red grenade.
Nah, it's fine. No, oh, come on. I cut that. I thought he was charging, not jumping.
Yeah, that's what I was hoping for too.
Oh well.
Oh, we'll just do that again.
I guess we're gonna. start by taunting them immediately.
Oh shit! Oh wait a second. Oh.
So I don't think we have Ripper mode. I think we have taunt.
Right. Oh shit.
This is a different button than the last time, I think.
Oh, that was an X.
That was an X.
Oh.
Also, these things are attacking weird.
Are X. They?
I need angles. There you go, got it. I could have got both, but at least I got one. Also, oh, I think we might have cut the other one.
The angles on that.
I think we killed both of them.
Oh yeah. Well, there you
go. Tinkle.
Okay. So it's not that they take and deal double damage. I don't think they take double damage as the thing said. I think they just die by Ripper mode. Like as if we were in Ripper mode. So we should probably taunt a lot. Also, I still don't know how to open these things.
Yeah, I don't know either.
I don't know. Saba, do you want to look that up real quick?
Open, what are these called?
I don't know. Lock chest, I guess.
Lock chest and Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. Because we've seen a lot of these, and we just got one for beating that VR mission. So in theory, we should be able to open it now.
Vengeance.
Oh, I wish we could hold it.
Locked boxes?
Yeah, sure, whatever.
Okay, open locked boxes.
Ghost.
This person was like, apparently no one has asked this question, and I would like to know.
Wait, hold on. Let me make him look directly into the camera.
Apparently that was a lie.
Nice.
Here is how it's done.
How long can that taunt go for?
I don't know. Why don't we hold one?
Enter blade mode, then slash it in blade mode? Is this the right one? You can try that. Let me know if
we're not. Blade we can't mode? Do blade mode because we're.
Oh, well, I don't know.
Oh, we can do blade mode. It is just blade mode. What are you talking about?
There you go.
Are you shitting me?
We did it.
Oh, that's so many upgrades we could have gotten.
You have to be super precise when slashing the lock on that box.
Or we could just slice 100 times.
Wait, is this blade move?
Greetings.
Oh,
are we gonna have a boss fight against Blade Wolf?
Blade Wolf.
Again?
Once again.
Literally the same thing as Raiden.
And you are? LQ84I, a prototype Eugene with a conversational interface.
A talking robot dog, basically?
State your business here.
Me?
I want to swim in the sewers.
Sharpening my skills. Wandering the earth, dispensing justice, but only to those who deserve.
You murdered two cops. Such as...
That's not justice. That's just dicks. Taking out a problem back.
You refer to World Marshal.
The ones holding your leash, right?
The ones who issue my orders.
And your orders are to kill me?
Yes.
Yes. Oh, he just wraps his little tendril around the thing?
I guess that's how it works.
That's stupid.
That's incredible.
I thought he like connected to it or something, like plugged in.
Wait, why did he suddenly stop?
We gave him some encouraging words. Order, my memory would be
wiped. Well, that's a pity. I am sorry. You must die.
You must die.
Oh no. Blade Wolf, no. As well.
Here we go again. Oh shit.
Good luck.
No way we're gonna lose a second time to him.
Oh, absolutely we are. I don't remember any of his patterns.
But we know how to parry. That's all we need. Oh shit. Oh shit.
I'm trying to parry.
Get it, bitch! Oh.
I can't parry. Oh no. I don't know if this is a good idea. Oh.
This might have been a terrible idea, taunting him.
Parry right into the chain. He's like, you're like, come at me, dog. And the dog's like, okay, just shove the chainsaw into your chest. And it's like, oh fuck.
Like, oh shit.
I mean, all things considered.
Oh my god.
All things considered equal, that wasn't that bad.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Not so ooh. That was pretty ooh.
So many oohs.
So many oohs. Ice!
Ice.
Ah, oh, brick.
I'm doing the normal parry timing.
Oh my god. He is not stopping his onslaught. And that's a tricky parry there. He kinda tricks you.
I guess so. I don't know. Maybe I'm just like misunderstanding the proper timing. I don't know.
It doesn't help that he immediately starts with the offense.
He drops his guard.
What do you mean?
You know how Raiden like holds the parry for like 6 seconds and it's a ridiculously long time?
Yeah.
I just watched Jet Stream Sam when there was nothing, like no attacks coming in, and he held it for like half a second and then dropped.
Oh, so it's tight.
So it's actual tight typing. Oh fuck.
Well, this is what you ask for.
It is literally what I asked for, but I'm not happy about it.
Oh, what you asked for
is bad.
That...
This is very poor. This is very poor. Dude, the camera,
man.
Oh my
god.
Isn't it the exact same thing that happened with the last Blade Wolf fight where it was like, dude, camera, come on.
Yep, it was exactly.
Okay, all right.
Jesus,
I need a refresh.
Christ.
I need a refresh. We got it. We'll beat Blade
Holy
Wolf again
shit.
Before the stream's over.
This is, again, the last thing that we're going to do. Oh, man. Hey, that was good. That was pretty ice.
I was ready for it. It was the thing. He drops. God, it's so tough.
Ice. God, that was out of brick.
That was brick. Dude, it's so rough. What the fuck? Why is Blade so much more
that
hard here?
So fast.
This is before Raiden fights him. I get this because he doesn't have multiple phases.
Maybe. Three hit combo, you son of a bitch.
One.
Oh my god.
Fuck.
Holy
close.
Hell.
Getting close. God, it's so relentless. It's so good, but I'm like, come on, give me a break.
Nice brick.
It's so tough. He's so relentless. Oh, no. Oh my god.
Good lord.
I'm trying.
Oh, this is what Blade Wolf is. It is only 100% capacity.
This is what Blade Wolf, like, this is what we're gonna play as.
Yeah. Holy shit. Oh man.
I love hearing Jetstream Sam just like screaming in agony. It's pretty funny. Yeah. Dude, I haven't even mentally recovered from the triple combo attack before he dashes. Oh, the mental damage, dude.
The mental. No! Oh my god.
Ice.
Oh. Oh my god. Oh no, not again.
If I was doing this on my own, this is where I would hit escape and just be like, restart.
Yeah.
I can't see shit!
Oh my god.
Camera, please!
The camera should be locked onto Blade Wolf, but it's just not.
I'm just gonna let us die, because the camera's clearly just fucking with us. Ugh! The camera is just like locking onto the pile of debris, and it's like, why? Is it because the camera doesn't want to spin that far? Probably, but still. Come on, oh. Dude.
Okay. Oh no.
That was me being dumb.
Oh no, not again. Not again! He does a little faint. That's nasty.
Now I'm just getting like pissed because I'm like, come on, dude.
Oh man! There's no breaks. No breaks here. Where the fuck are we?
No brick breaks here.
Oh no, it's just full on brick. There's no ice break. We're bricking every time.
I'm holding my breath so bricking and breaking. Hurting.
Dude, that's ice. And here's brick. Icy! Oh man. Never mind. Blade Wolf is icy all around. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, is this doomed camera?
Did you call it doomed camera?
Yeah, the doomed camera.
It's pretty good.
Oh shit!
What the fuck? Why'd we go up?
Do it again! Oh, okay. Never mind, don't do it again. Do it, bitch!
Alright, that was pretty funny. that was extremely ballsy and I appreciate it.
Oh my god, come on, man.
Literally couldn't have hit the button faster. I'm so pissed, man.
Zach is indeed pissed.
It's just like the timing is so tight. I don't understand how our first attempt was so like good compared to every attempt afterwards.
Oh no.
I don't know what to tell you, man.
Give me a second.
Oh, let's try.
He's gotta pull up the suspenders.
He'll pull up the suspenders.
Tighten the belt. Stupid bullshit.
Start stretching your hands.
I parried that. I promise you. Fuck you, Blade Wolf. God.
Oh, man.
I don't know. I don't understand what's happening.
Go back to your old timing.
No, but that's the thing, is that I am going back to my old timing, and it's just new timing isn't working, old timing isn't working. It's just like, I don't know. He just doesn't want to do it sometimes.
We are in the air. Define three attacks. That's two attacks. Son of a bitch.
Is that this? Nope, that one got us.
That was one of the better attempts. we are ready for that, you bitch.
I do want you to taunt him at some point. When he's really far away doing the knives, I want you to taunt him.
Not when he's charging like that.
Not when he's charging, yes, but yes, like this is perfect. Because I want. What the fuck happened?
He missed.
Combination complete.
Wait, did we just bounce off the wall?
We've been bouncing off the wall plenty of times,
really?
I'd say. Yeah.
Oh, that's so cool.
Every time he smashes up against it.
Blade Bolt,
thank you for telling
yourself.
Us that we will die. Where were you at during the fight against Senator Armstrong?
Yeah, exactly. Like, who? Like, where was this Blade Wolf, man? Like, yeah. The rest of the game, he was just, like, little puppy dog compared to this.
We like Blade Puppy.
Blade Puppy. Blade Pupper. X.
Let's go! Oh,
Jesus,
cut him up.
Christ.
Just
all right,
good old
got him.
Mince.
Fuck this guy. By the way, do you want to know what the difference between that attempt and every other attempt was?
They're gonna say literally nothing.
Correct! Nothing changed in how I played. It was just, it just worked this time.
You got lucky.
Now, I am quite good, you know.
I love bragging to Blade Wolf, being like, haha, I beat you, even after Blade Wolf killed us like 14 times.
It was very rough.
Wait, hold up. Unlocked endurance plus one for beating him? Oh no! That was very bad. I'm sorry. Oh no, we're gonna die here because of the flame. Just run away. Just unlock and just run away.
Wrong way. What the fuck?
I don't know. They're just like charging, so it's just knocking us back.
They just charge it in place.
Yeah.
Hit a Larry, and then.
Oh, because we're on alert. It's okay. Just hide.
It's cool.
Just hide.
Yeah. In the shadows. But our character model does not get any lighter than this.
Fuck.
Oh shit!
Just get him. We have to get him now.
Ooh, that was nice.
That was pretty good. Now run that way.
And run back
the corner. Okay. I think the two water skimmers are stuck on each other.
Yeah.
Okay, you now go what? To the thing.
Perfectly fine.
Okay, Jetstream Sam is going to take a minute to get used to.
Yeah. Good thing we have more of this stuff.
Oh!
Oh
wow,
boy.
I like how leggy the gecko is.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm trying.
How's the parrying going?
I'm working on it, Ari. Is it going well? No, you can see that. I'm hyperventilating mentally.
Mentally
I'm hyperventilating.
Oh,
No bueno. Okay, very nice.
Well,
I don't know why I did that. I was holding it a little too long. Oh, we're dead!
You're straight up dead. Jetstream Sam.
Jetstream Sam.
Let's snag this. Let's just wait in the corner.
We can't assassinate it. Well, I wanted to fight it. It's gonna come at us anyway, I guess.
Yeah, I just wanna just get the small dude first. Ah, it's far away.
Wait, where's the gecko?
I think he's still in the other room. Oh no! Alright. Alright. Where's he? Oh. Good parry. Not so good parry. Icy parry.
Why are you calling things icy now? Dude, we need to get the camera. Get the camera. Go fuck this guy. Go get the camera. Unlock. The camera shooting at us is causing me a bunch of fucking grief.
Oh,
all right,
fuck?
We're good.
Yeah, let's get back down here, buddy.
He's gonna jump.
Get some space.
He's gonna jump. He's not gonna jump.
Oh, perfect parry. Oh, with a weird angle. All right. Perfect. Perfect play. Oh, is this the elevator thing?
Hey, it's the elevator jab. Oh, double jump, right.
Double
Wait,
jump.
Is this going to be the same elevator challenge? Something?
Are we going down instead of up this time?
No, we're still going up. Because that's the only way that they designed the environment, right?
I guess so.
Oh, we're gonna meet do you think we're gonna do boss fights against like Mistral and Monsoon
so.
And stuff?
Like this time we'll beat you. Oh, get off. Oh, not again.
Like, he doesn't have combos. Like his only combos are waiting in between light strikes, you know? And it's a little weird, because like with Raiden, I had like bread and butter stuff that I could do. You know, the one where it was like slash, 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 and at the very end, you kick him.
Yeah.
I can't do that.
Copy.
You jump that?
Maybe it's different.
Oh,
but what the fuck?
Wait, eliminate all enemies. They're enemy back.
Oh. Oh my god. Hello, big man.
What the fuck?
Oh, that's new.
I haven't seen that before.
The fuck?
You locked on
that
to
worked.
Him, I guess? Is he dead? He's not dead. You're
he
still locked on to that man's. We continue to be locked on to that
changing.
Man's, although he does have a rocket, so I don't think it's wrong.
Okay, that fell.
Got it.
There you go.
It's only fine. We did it.
Everything's going great.
Everything is going
man.
Swimmingly.
We like swimmingly.
I want to do right, more taunts.
Yeah. Ooh, S waiting.
I don't know about S. Oh, could you imagine if the first boss fight we do is against Sundowner? And like we go backwards, like the final boss is Mistral.
That would be great. And Mistral's like for some reason way harder than she ever needed to be.
Oh god, it would be great if it was something along the lines of like Jetstream Sam. Wait, stop, turn around.
Oh.
Ah. I noticed it.
Well.
Because I have eyes in my head.
Are you sure about that?
I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure I do, because they hurt all the fucking time.
But are you sure that's not just a simulation?
They're gonna rocket us. They shot him. Okay. We should go after the rocket guys.
What? We can fall off? Okay.
Well, because this is a different arena.
They always had them all up. So.
Yeah. So I didn't really think about it. Oh, that's funny.
I think it'd have to be something to watch out for. Alright. Oh! What? Those guys. Oh, they're gonna shoot. Or not. Oh!
He just knocked the other guy off.
Oh.
Please,
be careful.
Please.
Do not get shot.
No!
You were inches away from turning into Tigger there, Lawrence.
Into Tigger.
Yeah, you just had to say one more who, and then you would have done it. No, no, it has to be who, 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 who. So close. Now you just turned into an owl.
Hi, bitch. What the fuck?
Because the target reticle's on the other guy, I guess.
Oh no!
That was quite a good.
All right,
taunt,
now they
Lawrence.
All have swords out, which I think is the best option for us.
Oh my god! There's so many directions getting attacked from.
Correct.
Oh.
Next. Holy
Yay.
Shit! We need a camera.
There you go.
All right, we're fine.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god!
No,
oh.
Big guy! Oh, come on! Alright, this sucks. I don't want to do this. It's fucking 9:57. We're at a checkpoint. Say we ended. Jetstream Sam is already fucking with my head. And my index finger hurts! Because all I'm doing is like light attack, light attack, light attack, light attack. Oh, he's open. Let's hold R and then light attack, light attack, light attack, light attack. Oh.
That's how we beat us, button mashing back in the beginning of the game.
Like, what is all the cool shit that Jetstream Sam was doing during his boss fight? Why don't we have any of that? But you remember when he would like backflip like halfway across the arena and then like charge at us and then strike? Why can't we do that? I guess because we're not there yet in the story.
We grow stronger.
All right. Well, that was great. So my suspicion is probably that. So the main campaign took us like 2 weekends, give or take a little. So my suspicion is that the Jetstream Sam campaign is probably going to take us Friday, Saturday. And then the Blade Wolf is going to take us the next Friday, Saturday.
It makes sense that it's shorter.
Yeah. So that should be good. So we'll be back tomorrow with. Can I? Yeah, I can exit from here. We'll be back tomorrow with Coin Game, but it's mostly just going to be a podcasty thing. So we'll still be, you know, doing that. I invited Grant, so if he's interested, he's free to, you know, join us. And what else? Do you guys this is me just offering, just because it's we're on like a funky schedule at the moment. But if it would be preferable to you guys, we could start a little later tomorrow.
Oh.
So instead of like
11,
yeah, so like instead of 11 a.m. for you guys, we could start at like noon.
Don't mind either way, I guess.
Yeah, it's just totally fine.
That doesn't actually like answer anything, because if you both say it doesn't matter, then we'll just stick with the regular time.
That's great, Lawrence. Like I said, something hoping maybe you can become the definite like person to say something,
right?
Which will make a decision.
12 then. 12.
Okay, so we'll be starting at noon Pacific tomorrow. We'll be going for about 4 hours. Yeah, I'll see y'all then.
See y'all then.
Good night, everybody.
Bye bye. Yes, Saba.
And did you still?
Good night, stream.